2-0. Glenn Howard 3-1. So two veteran teams moving on. One of the great stories of this week has been Daly Peters, son of Vic Peters. The 20-year-old was playing third for Vic. In fact, Daly's getting ready to go to the Canadian Juniors in Fredericton, New Brunswick, and compete there. So they had a bit of a struggle in the playoff round. The Peters team facing Glenn Howard, two very talented teams. When it was over, though, it was Glenn Howard of Ontario defeating the Manitoba rink of Vic Peters. And in the rematch of the Olympic gold medal final between Pal Trulson and Kevin Martin, this time a little measure of revenge for Kevin Martin as he defeated Pal Trulson. So now just four teams remain. And in semifinal action today, the first semifinal matches Ontario's Glenn Howard against Alberta's Kevin Martin. And the second semifinal, it's all Alberta between Randy Ferbey and John Morris. Pleased, as usual, to be joined by Marilyn Bodo and Ed Lukowich as we get ready for semifinal action. Marilyn, we're going to concentrate with you on that all-Alberta matchup. We've got Randy Ferbey and John Morris. But Randy Ferbey, they've been curling so well this year.
Well, the Ferbey foursome has shown absolutely no weakness for the season of 2005. They started with a win in Perth, Scotland, and they haven't stopped since, qualifying here in Winnipeg. And Dave Nedewin's got to feel good about it. He's in his hometown, birthplace of Winnipeg. Now, John Morris, I mean, you've got to give this team credit. They have taken these losses straight in the chin, come fighting off the canvas, and here they are, finally in the semifinal. Can they win? Well, I think they're really going to have to work hard in their communication, and the front end of Morris' team has to play out Ferbey's front end.
All right, Ed, let's talk about the second semifinal between Glenn Howard and Kevin Martin. A very important match, not just because it's a semifinal of a Grand Slam event, but the points available could determine who gets a spot in that Olympic qualifying tournament.
Right, Rob, when we talk about Olympic trials, this is really the more important of the two games. The Canadian team ranking system will give that 10th and final spot at the end of the year into the trials. Right now, it is Martin that leads Howard by 18 points, but there's a lot on the line today, point-wise. For Howard, with his new front end of Brent Lang and Craig Saville, they've had a great year so far, and they're looking to really do well. They're in the Ontario playdowns in Whitby, and if they could win the Brier, they would get a spot in the trials. If you look at the Martin team, they did not get into the Ontario Provincials. They will not be at Innisfail for the Provincials. However, in mid-March, they do have the Canada Cup. If they can win that, they will go straight into the trials. But the battle is really on today in that point system for the 10th and final spot into the trials.
Well, in the semifinal action, we will show you the first three ends of the Ferbey-Morris semifinal, then ends number four and five of the Martin and Howard, and then an all-star panel. Well, we're on the panel, so I don't know how much of an all-star panel it is. We'll determine what you will see for the final ends. All we know is you are going to see some terrific curling today. Semi-final action. Four teams remain. One will be crowned the Canadian Open champion, and it's coming up next. You're watching the Pharmacist Grand Slam of Curling, presented by M&M Meat Shops, and it's next.
Every day, you have to work at the things you love. It takes patience, motivation, and the support of those around you. Most of all, it takes time. Like Carrie Burdnick, our pharmacists take the time for you and your family. Visit one of our over 1,100 participating pharmacist pharmacies today. We take the time to care, and caring is the most important part of healthcare.
At M&M Meat Shops, we wanted our name to reflect more of what we offer.
Hello, M&M Meat, and hundreds of mouth-watering complete meals you can prepare quickly and easily to please the whole family shops. Can I help you?
But then again, why not just show you? Complete meals like New York strip loin with gourmet stuffed potato, stuffed turkey breast with farm vegetable blend, and desserts like chocolate caramel pecan cheesecake. M&M Meat Shops, hundreds of meal ideas, one aisle.
BDO Dunwoody is one of Canada's largest accounting and advisory firms and a very proud sponsor of curling.
At BDO, we believe that all players should be treated equally. As the title sponsor of the BDO Curling Classic, we offered a purse of $100,000 to both the men and the women.
Find out more about BDO Dunwoody at www.bdo.ca. BDO Dunwoody, driving growth.
When it's cooler outside, make it warmer inside. You can at the Home Depot. Right now's the perfect time Use your Home Depot consumer credit card and get no payments, no interest for 12 months on any kitchen, bath, or window treatment purchase of $450 or more. Nobody else has more know-how to make every dollar work harder. So go ahead, give your home a fresh start for the new year. Find more inspiration at homedepot.ca. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
Thank you for calling Altamira. This is Michael. How can I help you?
Hi. I'm just trying to figure out how to invest for retirement.
I'd be happy to help. Do you have some time right now?
Sure.
Great. I'll ask some questions about your retirement plans.
Go on.
Then we'll choose the right mix of investments for you. We're always here to help, even evenings and weekends.
So when do we get started?
We already have.
Every group has its leader. The one that everyone looks up to. The one that decides where the group should go. The one that everyone follows. Because they always have the best ideas. And the coolest toys.
Hurry into your Ski-Doo dealer today for great deals during the Ski-Doo Factory Clearance Event.
Rogers Sportsnet is proud to present the 2005 Canadian Open. Brought to you by Rexall Brand. Real value, priced right. M&M Meat Shops. Hundreds of meal ideas, one aisle. And by BDO Dunwoody Chartered Accountants and Advisors. Driving growth.
Welcome to the center of the country, Winnipeg, Manitoba, and this terrific MTS Center, the home of the Canadian Open. The crowds have enjoyed the curling, and they are ready to go. As we take a look at the semifinal, we'll be concentrating on for the first three ends, Randy Ferbey's team. Randy Ferbey skips and throws third stone. Dave Nedewin will throw the fourth rocks. Second is Scott Pfeiffer, and the lead, Marcel Rock. Against the young team, John Morris, the skip. Kevin Cooey is the third. Mark Kennedy, the second. And the lead, Paul Moffitt. Randy Ferbey will be throwing the Yellowstones. John Morris has the Blue Rocks. And ready to go, semifinal action. Ferbey, Morris, and Martin and Howard. And we will keep an eye on the other semifinal for you so you don't miss any of the terrific action.
Well, Rob, you talked about the crowds here at the MTS Center, and it's been absolutely phenomenal. The electricity and everything, the energy in this whole arena has been outstanding.
Here's Marcel Rock, hometown Edmonton. He's been with Randy Ferbey for 8 years.
Tremendous lead player. I would really say he's probably the strongest sweeper in the world. Very, very strong on the sweeping. Like they're playing this one. Big thing here, I think, in this first end for Morris to win the draw to the button and get the hammer. And Ferbey's had his number over the years, so Morris has that early advantage with the hammer. Didn't expect that, Ferbey going into the rings.
Here's young Paul Moffitt, who's born in Kingston, now lives in Calgary.
Second year with this team as he moved west with John Morris when John relocated to Calgary.
Well, you have to feel for the Morris team here. They've only won once against Ferbey in 9 outings, so it's a tough match for them.
So why did Ferbey go into the rings with that opening shot? You know, he's always going out front. Is this some kind of new strategy on his part?
Yep.
Could be. They have a point to prove here. They've gone out and played the circuit full-time to make full-time paychecks, and I think they've done a pretty good job of it.
Marcel with an outturn hit. Strongest sweeper on the combination of Huff and Puff, so we saw Huff there first. This team, our tour champions from last year, is in St. John's, Newfoundland. It was the Morris team that took home the Players' Championship.
They'll be looking for a repeat again at Mile One Stadium in March. Rules of play on the Grand Slam Tour. Four-rock rule is in effect in the three-guard zone. Each team is allowed 75 minutes to play. They have 2 1-minute timeouts they can use.
Up,
first.
Playing.
Yep. Yep. Hey, yep.
Scott Pfeiffer, left-handed player, with his outturn hit and stay.
No. Well, follow
Scott, the second part of that huff and puff combination. Puff going with the name Pfeiffer. P&P.
And Mark Kennedy, the second. Hometown, St. Albert, Alberta.
Take a really good look at Mark's game today. He's really going to have to pick up his pace, and he's competing against Pfeiffer, who we know is very solid at his game.
That's a good point, Marilyn. You know, I usually say it's the best second in the world that wins these championships. And Mark is really in tough today against Scott Pfeiffer, who is probably, as a left-hander, I would say the top left-handed player in the world. Now, we might have somebody like Bruce Corte dispute that a little bit, but I love his backswing delivery for a young player who still uses the backswing. And when he comes out of the hack, it's just picture perfect.
He's in his eighth year with the Ferbey team. $100,000 prize money at the Canadian Open. The champion takes home $30,000. Second place, $18,000. And those in the semis, $12,000. Fifth to eight. If you qualify, $7,000. One thing we can tell you about that semifinal money, knowing that there is $12,000 in your pocket, it's made a millionaire out of the Kevin Martin team. Since 92, that team's won $1 million curling.
Yeah, they went over the line this week, and boy, that's really something fantastic. Right, and if you look at what the success they've had in skins games and on the tour and the slams over the years, they've managed to add it up.
Well, that's the unofficial announcement. We're waiting for the total official $1 million announcement.
Well, where does that come? At the bank? When they shake your hand and make the next
from
deposit?
From the boys upstairs, you know, that add it all up.
Randy Ferbey skips the team and throws the third stones. Most famous Brier player of all time, having won five Briers. The only man to do that and the only man to win three in a row. This team winning three in a row, almost four in a row, as they just kind of got scalped in the final last year right at the end by Dacey.
Well, they have to be playing pretty relaxed here in Winnipeg. All they have to do is win money.
Well, they've had success in Winnipeg before. They won a Worlds here just 2 years ago.
Kevin Coy from Yellowknife. He and John Morris have kind of flip-flopped back and forth, Vice and Skip and throwing
Real
final
hard.
Stones.
I think the way John feels when he's been skipping for like 10 weekends in a row, he sort of needs a weekend off. But I want us to look at the communication between these two players. Between Kevin and John. Got to step up. It's got to be more detailed. And I think Kevin has to be a little bit more vocal.
Perhaps he's not quite enough of an engineer in some of their wins. And, you know, it'd be interesting to kind of talk about today for our viewers as to why this Ferbey team has absolutely dominated Morris over the years. They're 9-1. And going back to the Brier in 02 in Calgary, they basically wrapped it up with a big four-ender in the fifth end, and during the fifth end break interview, John Morris basically said, conceded, right, we're done, but we'll play the last few ends.
Mm-hmm.
So there is a bit of a mental block when it comes to them playing this Ferbey team.
It just takes one big win here for that breakthrough to happen.
A lot of glide there on that final stone by Randy Ferbey.
The two lowest sliders on the ice here are Kevin Cooey here and second Mark Kennedy. And you don't see that many players on the tour nowadays slide that low, you know, and I think that tends to generally, I would feel that generally tends to hurt the soft weight shots, and maybe that's what they're missing.
Well, you know, for Kevin Cooey, he's such a big guy, and for such a big guy to get down this low is absolutely amazing. His flexibility is like 100%.
And we'll see Dave Nedewin and his first rock of the first end. Very clean first end.
Yeah, unexpectedly so. You know, probably in the last 4 or 5 years, I have never seen Ferbey without the hammer play. Maybe it was just a mistake that they went into the rings and then decided to hit. Perhaps Marcel was just overweight in his first one. And they gave us no indication that it was a mistake. They're keeping it a dark secret, and maybe they want Morris to think that too.
David, born and raised here in Winnipeg, feels quite at home. Actually, he only moved out to Alberta in 97.
Well, he formerly had this same situation. He curled with Arnold Ashen, where Arnold skipped the game and Dave threw the skip stones. And so he was pretty comfortable when he moved to Alberta and hooked up with the Randy Ferbey team.
First for John Morris. John was born in Ottawa.
Oh, he was born here in Winnipeg. Lived here for one whole year.
But Ottawa is what he calls his home.
Ottawa is what he calls his home.
No, it's Calgary that he calls his home.
Okay, let's get this
straight. Didn't he play in Kitchener too?
Went to university in Kitchener.
Yeah.
Well, his father being Earl Morris certainly, you know, was with the army and moved all over the place in Canada. And so John, I think, has seen most of this country.
You know, and he doesn't classify himself or his team as a team that really dominates with big scores. He likes to claw his way through a lot of events and kind of get going and then really turn it on at the end, as we saw him do in the Players' Championship last year.
And he might be keeping an eye on Sheet C, Kevin Martin and Glenn Howard's team, because Glenn Howard has his old front end of Saville and Lang.
Nedwin, who does water skiing in the summer, championship skiing. A very good athlete. Very routine first end, and we'll look at John Morris as he attempts the blank.
Can you imagine? Oh, yeah, give me a 2-3.
That was fun.
The front end making sure the ice is clean, doing a lot of housekeeping, making sure they're not going to get picks. Any kind of debris can cause the stone to pick, so these sweepers like to clean at least two-thirds of the way down the sheet before the throwing of a stone, especially a skips rock, the all-important ones.
And just looking for the blank, he'll get it. Moving on to end number two in one of the semifinals. And the hammer still belongs to John Morris. Good look at Winnipeg, one of the snow sculptures, and trying to sculpture a champion inside the MTS Center.
Swiss Chalet has always been the place to go with a healthy appetite. But what if you want wholesome choices? We've got them. Our chicken is slow cooked on a rotisserie. Our famous sauce is low calorie and low fat. And now our fresh cut fries are cooked in trans fat free oil. Consider that great news for your home team. Swiss Chalet, food you can feel good about. Walmart, working twice as hard to save you even more. Always.
Hey, who shipped the 200 boxes to our client in Boston? Was it you, Lewis?
I shipped them with FedEx.
You're a heck of a man doing a heck of a job, Lewis.
Trust the company with proven reliability. Relax, it's FedEx.
It's not about the money, the glory, or stepping up to the podium knowing you're number one. It's about taking the time to do your best. Like Kevin Martin, our pharmacists take the time. Time to care for you and your family. And caring is the most important part of healthcare. Talk to your local pharmacist at one of these fine stores.
At M&M Meat Shops, we wanted our name to reflect more of what we offer.
Hello, M&M Meat, and hundreds of mouth-watering complete meals you can prepare quickly and easily to please the whole family shops. Can I help you?
But then again, why not just show you? All your party foods and complete holiday meals, like stuffed turkey breast with farm vegetable blend. And decadent desserts, like chocolate caramel pecan cheesecake. M&M Meat Shops, hundreds of meal ideas, one aisle.
Thank you for
calling Altamira. This is Catherine. How can I help you?
Hi there. I need to speak to someone about making my RRSP contribution.
No problem. I can do that for you right now.
Really? How does that work?
Well, we'll put your money into the Altamira High Interest Cash Performer.
You get a terrific interest rate and a tax receipt right away.
Nice.
Then we'll set up an appointment to do some long-term investment planning when it's convenient for you.
Our semifinal update between Glenn Howard and Kevin Martin. Final stone for Glenn Howard. There's a Martin rock right there. They got rid of it and a blank end for them in the first end of the semifinal. So blank ends both sides round. Everybody holds onto the hammer. And we'll move back to the semifinal. We will pay attention to for the first three ends. Morris.
Okay, you're by.
And Ferbey. Yeah.
Well, they got it right this end. Marcel got a guard out in front, and Morris went straight behind. Marcel came to the button, and here's the last lead stone for the Morris team, and pretty tough to blank this one.
Very tough. I was saying that in the break there, I hadn't seen an opening end like that for years in the Grand Slam. Seemed very unusual.
Scott Pfeiffer with his normal large percentage, 96% in the quarterfinal.
Seven.
And they really had a great quarterfinal. They played Jean-Michel Menard of Quebec and
seven.
Won that 10-2. Nope. They got four on eight. The first end, and we're up 8-1 after five ends and just basically cruised or mailed it in after that.
Yeah. But I would keep my eyes on that Quebec team. They're a very strong, finesse-playing team, so they'll be tough in their Quebec provincial.
I would agree. Right now, I'd say that Menard is the best team in Quebec and has an excellent chance to go to the Briar.
Quite a surprise, too, the way they came in and went 3-1. Everybody said, where did these guys come from?
Little taps okay, too, but T-line.
Mark Kennedy drilled 76% in the quarterfinal.
It's like more than years.
He was a member of the University World Champion team from Canada 2 years ago in Italy.
Line's good. Room. There. Clean. Wait there.
And this is the type of shot, as you mentioned, Marilyn, where he really has to be up to it.
Line only.
He's got to play a great soft game.
Well, 76% at second doesn't cut it on the Grand Slam, and, you know, we really got to play those big key shots.
And although a shot looks like often it's made, it's just the perfect positioning of the stones that is so key.
Same weight, or what do you want?
Wanted a little more curl to that stone.
Okay.
Now blue 1-2.
How much more? 10.
Scott Pfeiffer. Known as Puff, he loves these soft weight shots.
Eight.
May want to explain too. They wanted a 10 on the weight. Ed.
Well, they use a numbering system, and one is just over the hog line, two halfway to the hog, three close to the rings, and you get to the button. It's a 5, and 10 would be just through the rings. So the bigger number, a little bit more weight, and they use that rather than having to, you know, use a dictionary and say, well, it's top ring or top 4-footer back ring. They just use the numbering system. They've used it for years.
And you could hear Dave Nedewin and Marcel Rock say that's a 7-8, so it wasn't going to be through the rings the way Randy Ferbey had asked.
It's a fight for the 4-foot here between these two teams, and as we've always mentioned, Robin, Maryland, that control area,
8-foot
or top 4-foot, very important to have your stones in that control position, where you can tap up or play a raise.
Rock placement is so important.
Three-way measure.
Haven't seen much of this other turn so far. But good movement here. Generally, we're getting 4 feet of curl.
John's given Mark Kennedy a good chunk of ice.
Oh, this is tons.
And they're yelling heavy. Kui says heavy right out of Mark's hand.
3-7-2 the split. Get the split times in the top right of your screen. Help you at home keep track of where this rock might end up.
That split time going from back line to first hog, the sweepers keep track of that. Pretty nice weight and good positioning.
And let's take a look at the the times for you that you'll see on the screen and how they do time it.
And that key interval time, 3.80 to the button, that's what we would get when this guy comes up with draw weight, he crosses the back line, and then a time it takes to go to the first hog line to the release. The sweepers are timing that, and just as soon as they get a 3.8, they know that is generally what it has been and should be good draw weight. If it goes through quicker, that means less time, the player could be heavy.
Well, we all know that these time watches are only used as a barrier for the players to feel it, but a lot of players are, have to go by gut, especially when you're playing on arena ice. You've got to know when that ice is going to change.
That
if
one
it
was,
does.
That would be 3.52, so likely heavy.
That was an example for you from their warm-up. Randy Ferbey delivering now.
Where is it?
It was 2 years ago that he had a knee operation, but he quickly recovered, and 3 weeks later he was throwing stones and winning our Sportsnet Skins game over Christmas, and they won it again this year.
You know, since he told everybody that he was going to retire, he has curled so well. He hasn't been under 90% in about a year or two.
Well, for showing out with a blaze of glory, then, if he's doing it this way.
For sure. I phoned their team in Nipawin and got a hold of him this year. Randy, I says, how are you doing? He says, well, I'm the only guy healthy. I'm the oldest guy.
Well, his row, they've been in 11 events, qualified in 10, and to the semifinals. They open up with a loss in the round robin to Vic Peters, with his son Daly playing with him, a loss to Burtnick, but then big wins, 10-7, 10-2 in the quarterfinal against Menard.
And in the round robin, he got a 4 against Morris, and in the 10th end to finish that one off 9-7.
I think you got to get the shooter out here.
Well, it's really their 15th event because they did play the Rogers Sportsnet Skins game over the Christmas holidays, won that, and then they won in Scotland a week later.
Good normal, actually.
So they say it's their 15th week.
That was a good spell for them, too, taking the big money out of the Skins game and then going to Perth.
Actually, they won quite easily in Perth. It just seemed like no one's going to stop them.
Hard!
Nice shot.
Well, that moves from Granite around indeed.
Counting two is Morris.
John Morris played in 9 events, qualified in 4. Here's another look at that terrific shot.
Well, big shot for Kevin Cooley. You've got to make these raised back hits to get your rocks in the right position. He's got the hammer this end. You've got to make sure you score your deuce.
Yeah, you could double them out.
Maybe that's not a bad call.
Yeah, if you can see enough and you like it, I don't mind it.
Well, if we reckon a guard, what does he do? He's throwing a guard.
Uh-huh. Throw a guard, yeah. Yeah, it's kind of, you got to make it if you're going to play it. Otherwise, we got to come in and just bump them.
Let's throw peel.
Okay.
Don't mind a peel, Darren.
And for John Morris, win-win-win to start things off. First loss was to Ferbey, 10-7, as you mentioned, Maryland, in the opening, that they've had a struggle against this Ferbey team, and then a 10-6 quarterfinal win over Kerry Burtnick.
A couple of things stand out there. First of all, Hemmings is just not clicking this year, so Hemmings loses again, and John Morris was doing good against this team until the 10th end, and then it was once again Ferbey coming up with the big win.
Warren Peel Wade trying to bump them out. Moves the Morris stone right on the button.
Well, the last time they played, Morris was one up coming home, so it was a match. It was a close one.
Yeah, you got to be there. You just hit that one right there, right?
He wasn't at all.
Yeah, but what do you do?
Or here. Throw top button.
You can get rid of it.
If your line's good, you can top it a bit, eh? Sure.
What?
If the line's good, we can even top this a smidge.
Yeah, it'd be after.
Because this isn't very good if you just go top 8.
I don't think we can run off.
Top button.
There's Paul Trulsen, 2002 Olympic gold medalist from Norway. They played very well, had a terrific tiebreaker victory against Wayne Madaw. He made some outstanding shots in that game.
They were unstoppable, and it wasn't that Wayne Madaw's team played poorly or anything. They got no breaks, and Trulsen just, they made everything everywhere.
It's going to bounce. Whoa.
No bounce. Stay with it.
Never.
Never. Come on.
A bit of a bounce. And see there, just that couple inches off in weight, and
in line and calling.
They quite often get caught in that, and they've got somebody in trouble, and they don't quite put the screw on real tight.
Little fine detail that this team needs to take care of.
Probably going to come off that three and out.
Well, it depends, yeah. It might go right through there. He's going to have a hit there, maybe, or something, or a bump. He's going to be bumping that six rock. I think we have to play that.
Well, that's what I thought, is play it thin and try and get them both. But, if it hits and gets four rock.
Actually, we'll do it. So you're throwing peel at this thing.
Yeah.
Okay.
Can you see it? Can't see very much. Just hit what we can see. Oh, no, you can see a third, quarter.
Yeah. Going to have to be a shot extraordinaire here from Dave Nedwin, but he can make those. They need almost as little as they can get of this. Well, probably about an eighth. Get the top blue and the back blue as well.
It's amazing what one little guard can do to generate this whole end.
Yeah, you only need the one guard and a bunch of rocks behind it to... And it's amazing how that one guard blocks a lot of shots that would be normally wide open.
Yeah, sometimes it's your friend and sometimes it's your foe.
Hard! Is it through?
No, it overcurled by quite a ways. Didn't come anywhere close to getting the top one. And we've seen that from Dave probably in the past, that sometimes he can get this outturn going.
Well, they got on it right away. Swept it all the way down. Barely gets by the guard. Hits it too thick.
No.
Yeah, they wanted a little skinnier hit on that.
Well, Dave knows that he's opened the door here for the Morris team.
He's only shot the trees.
You don't really want what happens if you tap.
Morris with the hammer.
Well, that's if the weight's heavy, then we go. Like, if we tap it and roll there, it's not too bad.
Mark threw out here. And it was definitely a bit slower than there, but this is pretty close to where he threw that draw.
This is where I threw the draw. I'm going to go edge of eight.
Tell him they just need T line.
A question here, Marilyn. You know, this Morris team, from the start of the year, they did some work with the Canadian Curling Association with the Performance Center in Calgary, took a week off to work on that. Do you think that at this stage they benefit much from a coach?
What?
Like, neither one of these teams are really using any kind of coach. You know, they're basically they're working
out
themselves.
Yeah, we can touch it to line.
I think it's a mistake if you don't have a coach these days. You've seen in the women's play, take for instance Manitoba, played in a situation here. When the last time a women's Manitoba team has won the Canadian championship. These are fine details we're going to have to look forward to.
Well, the coach certainly can spot something in your play, from up in the stands that perhaps you don't see as a player.
Right up. Clean. Yep. Hard. Hard. Yep. Hard. Sweep it, guys. Come on.
Couldn't quite talk the boys into sweeping that real hard, but it looks pretty good from here.
Kevin Cooey thought the weight was just a little stronger on that side, so John made sure that he was there rather than be short.
You
could also hear Moffitt say to him, Johnny, trust me here. We knew where it was. Because John, you could hear John wanting it swept.
Why, Scott, and you're giving him three all day?
I don't know how we keep him from getting three.
I think we have to go here.
How's that? You mean to get the top rock right out?
Yeah.
Double it off that one?
Well, you won't get the back one out there.
No, but you have to throw enough weight, and then you get by the guard, it might still jam.
I like this.
Does he get three if we put it there anyways, though, Randy?
Here?
Yeah, because he just hits his six rock with the...
Well, we got these ones here. Where's the shooter going to go?
No,
the shooter's not going to beat the one.
I know, but I'm just saying, if ours is right here, and he bumpers it onto this, does he push this rock back and get three? All you got to do is nudge those for a shooter to...
Maybe. I don't know. I don't know how it's going to really line up.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Is it better just to nudge this?
No, but if he throws some weight, this is going to roll out then if he throws any kind of weight.
But I'm just saying, if we actually move this back to here, then when he comes down, there's no way that he's getting both of these out because it's not going to move his seven rock.
Right.
So it's actually better to move that, not dead.
Well, as long as we don't roll off.
No, don't roll off. I mean
you can't see none of it, though.
Freeze is okay. I'm just saying, if we can move it 5 inches, it's better.
Yeah.
Well, they talked about this, bringing in the freeze on the turn there and weld it. Get that welding torch out, and perhaps Dave says even tap it just a little bit.
If he's going to get it, it's only for two.
I think it's a prevention shot to stop the 3-under from going on.
Yeah, there is no good hit situation for them here, so they're going to have to save it with a freeze. Dave says we move it 6 inches, maybe we only give up the 2.
Seven, eight.
Dave's final rock in the second end.
Huff and puff on the sweep.
Well,
whoa, 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 whoa. Clean.
They're going to have to be attentive here.
Come down real hard on this side.
Just nudges the guard.
That was a sweeping error.
And it just gives a big, big pocket here that John Morris can come into for his 3-under. Wow, what a start he can get off to.
Well, all the way down, they really didn't hammer it. And at the very end, no one could stop that one from crashing.
It looked like, as far as it went, he probably had a little bit too much weight. They were waiting for the weight to come down, and the curl happened right there.
It's close, so keep locking stuff.
Anything to the inside of the yellow here, and John Morris will collect 3 points. And
he just played this shot.
Well, it shows on the tour how important that draw to the button is to have that hammer. John Morris has that.
387, the split time. You said in your diagram earlier, Ed, 380 is both button.
Well, they hit it hard right out of his hand and kept it alive, so there's lots of weight there.
Curl, curl, Fredo, Fredo. Curl.
Looking like 2.5.
Deuce.
Didn't quite curl enough for the sure 3 there. Could be a measure.
The difference of jumping it and not getting it on soon enough makes a world of difference at the other end.
Well, I feel this is a huge measure here. There's a big difference between 2 and 3.
Looks like it's 2, maybe 3. Let's go to the other semifinal between Glenn Howard and Kevin Martin. After a blank in the first end, Howard still with the hammer.
Well, there's not much room here past the guard at the 12 o'clock, right on the center line at the top of the rings. Glenn's going to have to come close to that with a halfway tap, but he could get 3. He could manufacture a 3-under.
He was tight on line with that one. Richard just yelled right out of his hand, too.
Sable and Lang going real hard on the sweep. Thereby. Now, what do they get?
Bump the yellow. Looks like
a 3-under.
3 for Glenn Howard. Good start. Well, after the blank, he does good work on the second end and takes the lead against Kevin Martin. Dave Nedewin marches back. We're waiting for the final announcements. It's either 2 or 3 for John Morris.
Every day, you have to work at the things you love. It takes patience, motivation, and the support of those around you. Most of all, it takes time. Like Carrie Burtnick, our pharmacists take the time for you and your family. Visit one of our over 1,100 participating pharmacist pharmacies today. We take the time to care, and caring is the most important part of healthcare.
At M&M Meat Shops, we wanted our name to reflect more of what we offer.
Hello, M&M Meat, and hundreds of mouth-watering complete meals you can prepare quickly and easily to please a whole family shop. Can I help you?
But then again, why not just show you? Complete meals like New York strip loin with gourmet stuffed potato, stuffed turkey breast with farm vegetable blend, and desserts like chocolate caramel pecan cheesecake. M&M Meat Shops, hundreds of meal ideas, one aisle.
BDO Dunwoody is one of Canada's largest accounting and advisory firms, and a very proud sponsor of curling.
At BDO, we believe that all players should be treated equally. As the title sponsor of the BDO Curling Classic, we offered a purse of $100,000 to both the men and the women.
Find out more about BDO Dunwoody at www.bdo.ca. BDO Dunwoody, driving growth.
Hey, who shipped the 200 boxes to our client in Boston? Was it you, Lewis?
I shipped them with FedEx.
You're a heck of a man doing a heck of a job, Lewis.
trust the company with proven reliability. Relax, it's FedEx.
If you love your car, you want to treat it right. And nothing treats your car better than the hard-working family of Gunk car care products. Whether it's fuel and oil additives, lubricants, or cleaning products, Gunk gets the job done right. So for a cleaner, brighter, shinier, squeak-free, and smoother-running car, trust Gunk. Gunk, trusted by professionals and do-it-yourselfers alike since 1931. Look for Gunk products at these fine stores.
Well, the measure in place, and they said, no, it's only going to be two blue, not three. So Morris, probably a little disappointed with the turn of events, could have had a nice three on his side, has a 2-0 lead. Glenn Howard with three against Kevin Martin. MTS Center in Winnipeg, Manitoba. Marilyn Boto and Ed Lukowich. I'm Rob Faltz. This is the third stop on the Grand Slam Tour, the Canadian Open.
Well, those are the fine details we've been talking about, Ed, when we talk about the John Morris team. Combination there of miss-sweeping, a little bit too much ice, a little bit too much weight.
For sure, in a curling game, three is three times as much as two. That extra point is huge. And they might miss that somewhere along the line when you don't get that freebie on the board.
After this end, we'll be joining
maybe good control.
Martin Howard semifinal.
Ball throw normal.
We'll come up
or ends
here.
Four and five. So you get a full opportunity to see as much of each semifinal.
The fifth shot of the end here, so we're now through the four rock rule. Mark Kennedy.
And the yellow out.
And when was the last time, Robin Maryland, we had two left-handers at the same position against each other? I don't think we've had that for many years.
It's pretty unique.
Pfeiffer being asked to take care of business here, first of all, try to clean up the middle, and perhaps then they will be able to make use of the corner guard.
Lively house shown there.
For John Morris, he's up 2-0 here. He's thinking defense right now with the peel.
Could try
but
that.
It's so early in the game.
I don't think so, John.
So early in the game, it's better to stay on offense,
right
his
now.
Team says.
All right. Normal
feel. It's a long game to carry just a 2-point lead, so you have to look for more at this stage. If it was the eighth end or so, certainly they could go peeling. Eighth or ninth
six.
End.
Wait only.
Wait, it's pretty close.
Room.
Six.
Whoa. Whoa, switch. Nothing. Nothing.
Some interesting calls on that. They used the number system that the Ferbey team uses as well. They also yelled switch. Generally what these teams do is the inside sweeper to the stone, the one closest to the stone, is towards the direction of curl that can really hold the rock straight. But when a rock isn't moving enough, quite often they do a switch. And we will see that the Ferbey team excellent at doing that.
Clean, yep.
You see the men's teams doing it, but not so much in the women's tour.
Why do you think that is?
Maybe we just don't believe it works.
And a gentle roll into the center line.
Well, on the tour, it was really the four Park brothers from Edmonton that we saw using that the most with the inside sweeper to the direction of curl.
Hack.
They use it all the time, and most of the teams now do work to have, they really look to have a sweeper on each side of the stone so they can use that system.
Or more.
Nice shot by Scott as he got in behind cover. And this is an important shot in the game. You know, you want to keep the other team down on the farm. You don't want to just right give off. Them a break and let them right back into the game.
All right, Kev.
Got it, and main thing, number one, he got it out of there.
Got it out of there. Weight could have been just a little softer on that shot.
Well, this ice is absolutely perfect for playing those soft weight chase shots because you can really control them with the sweep. The Ferbster going down to throw his opening rock of this third end, and an unusual position for them, being behind John Morris. That's usually not their pattern with Morris. They've really manhandled him over the years.
Randy Ferbey taking less ice than John Morris did for this intern draw.
Line's good.
See where it ends up.
Oh, yep.
Line only.
Oh. Yep.
There we see Scott to the inside towards the direction of curl.
Oh.
He can get more pressure on that inside edge and keep it straighter.
No way.
No.
Is it not a whole pile of curl?
Yeah, just a hair deep. It'll afford a freeze opportunity for the Morris team.
The World Curling Tour, the money list this season. Kevin Martin with 85,000 plus on the tour. Randy Ferbey at 79. That will change with semifinal money and whatever he pulls out of the Canadian Open. John Morris, 17th. But that shows he's been in nine events and just qualified at four.
Unofficial money, though, that does not count any of the skins games, where some big money has been taken home this year.
Line's good, yep.
Martin winning $100,000 in one skins event, and Ferbey $40,000 in another.
Harder.
Hair short, but pretty good. If you're going to air, that's the side to miss on.
Well, Mark Sherrick, our ice technician here for the Grand Slam, is once again in his hometown. Made some great ice for these players to play on.
How about we try the split?
Nice curl.
Try the split?
Yeah.
Sure.
Ooh, that is one tough split. It's
off the face?
No, because
you go the other way and miss it, you're pumping him in for shot.
Yeah, I don't want to pump it. Oh, no.
I doubt that they could get them both in the rings. This rock is a long way out, but they certainly could get one in behind the corner guard and open it up.
Now, this is a great call. It's a hard shot to make, but when you've got the hammer, these are some of the detailed shots you've got to execute.
Are they going to make a liar out of me and get them both in the rings?
There's one.
Hang on, baby, hang on.
The other one's going to stick around,
wow.
Is it? It
does. What a shot.
Randy Ferbey, this is a normal kind of thinking mode he's in. It doesn't matter where the rocks are, he's making them.
We're trying to go by.
No, he didn't, Dave. We knew what you were doing there.
What does he do?
I don't know.
That is an incredible shot. I used to hate this shot if anybody ever made it against me. Now what do? Everything's wide open.
Well, you have to play a pick.
And credit to, you know, the front end of Ferbey. I mean, they know not to sweep it. They can feel the momentum of the rock.
Well, you look at the weight he had. He had enough weight to go right through the rings. They had to make the right contact. It all turned out good for the Ferbster, and they shot.
Even if I touch this and roll this to here.
Yeah, but I don't need to do that.
Big decision for John to make.
If he guards and misses his guard, he could give up four. If he plays the hit straight back, Nedwin has a double to lie three.
Well, because this is easier, eh? Because the yellow's on the other side of it, right? So if any of you wanted to be hitting this side, that's why. I could, if I roll in 2 feet, I'm hooping that. If I roll in 2 feet there, I'm fine.
Well,
I got to roll to the absolute perfect.
Even rolling back here is.
Yeah.
Do we need to throw peel? I don't think we want to move that.
Okay, just firm then.
Okay.
Firm won't move it more than a foot. Right there.
I like the decision here to hit one of the side ones. You know, quite often when you're in trouble, hit something away from the plate, let the other team come in and set you up.
Or 5 feet.
Well, do you think he could hit enough of that rock and roll in front of the shot rock?
That's a long way to roll.
It's a long, dangerous roll, but I mean, it would be fantastic to make.
The other thing he could have done here was buried behind the corner guard, but that might set up a double, too, and a four-bagger. John goes, why me?
Whoa!
He's looking great, and all of a sudden he's in trouble.
Roll it!
Ooh.
It is just on.
Yeah, only fourth shot stone.
That's what I'm looking at. I think
We
can make it with bumper and sit three?
try it, dude.
I think.
Yeah, keep it up there.
If we roll out, we roll out.
I thought I was tight.
You heard the comment of John Morris, and sometimes perspective from the other end to one other end is different.
Yeah, a chance here for Ferbey to make a play on that and move the blue out and get a roll right in behind the corner guard. He'd like to stay away from setting up any type of double for Morris on his last stone.
You know what Randy Ferbey has been doing really well is calling from Dave Nettowin's hand. He can just absolutely see by his release exactly what he does.
These guys are brilliant on the call of sweep, although they messed it up last end, but they are tremendous on the call of sweep.
Got to catch this ball on the outside and watch the roll behind the corner guard.
Ooh, nudges the back. Yellow.
Well, that's the second time that we've seen Dave over curl on his out turn. He's throwing that a bit soft.
You've noticed that from the Connell Cup, too. From then on in, it's been the same consistent release.
Just hack.
I don't think you have a ton of it.
Let's go to the other semifinal we'll be following shortly.
And it's Kevin Martin in one pile of trouble. He trails at 3-0. And is being asked to come up with the goods on his last shot of this third end.
Line's good. Yep.
Sweep.
Just case T line.
It's all up to the sweepers now.
We're all there. We're all there. We're heavy. We're heavy.
Play a tip.
Whoa.
Can always depend on Don Bartlett's word on the sweep.
Ooh, right through.
It's a steal.
It is a steal.
Steal of one
for Glenn Howard, and he will take. Looks like just one. The way they are looking, so for Glenn Howard, he would take a 4-0 lead.
Curl.
John Morris trying to curl enough to get to this side rock.
Mark. Go.
He may roll. How far will he go? Right out the back door. And we're close with those tiny biters, one back at the 7 o'clock position and one over at the 2:30. But it looks like only a hit for two here for Nettowin.
Final stone coming up in the third end. For the Ferbey team against John Morris.
Now, John just covering up his mic there as he's perhaps talking with his boys about something that he doesn't want on air. Now, that was a big shot. If he could have hit and stayed, he would have actually really forced the Ferbey team to think about gambling on a double, and if you don't make the double, then you're down some more. But this is pretty routine now for Mr. Dave Nettowin.
And the last rock at the third end.
Nettowin during the Continental Cup threw the most expensive curling rock in history, $75,000 on one stone.
Clean.
The final rock of the Continental Cup for the North American side.
Maybe curling can be a full-time job.
Bumps in. There's two. They are going to measure the ones that are biting on the edge, but right now we know it's at least a tie. Could it be more for the Randy Ferbey team? We'll be switching over to follow the Howard Martin squad as Randy Ferbey and John Morris are in a tight one. But coming up, Glenn Howard and Kevin Martin. You're watching the Pharmacist Grand Slam of Curling presented by M&M Meat Shops, the Canadian Open from Winnipeg.
It's not about the money, the glory, or stepping up to the podium knowing you're number one. It's about taking the time to do your best. Like Kevin Martin, our pharmacists take the time. Time to care for you and your family. And caring is the most important part of healthcare. Talk to your local pharmacist at one of these fine stores.
At M&M Meat Shops, we wanted our name to reflect more of what we offer.
Hello, M&M Meat, and hundreds of mouth-watering complete meals you can prepare quickly and easily to please the whole family shop. Can I help you?
But then again, why not just show you? All your party foods and complete holiday meals, like stuffed turkey breast with farm vegetable blend. And decadent desserts, like chocolate caramel pecan cheesecake. M&M Meat Shops, hundreds of meal ideas, one aisle.
the curling news, eh?
Subscribe today.
When it's cooler outside, make it warmer inside. You can at the Home Depot. Right now's the perfect time. Use your Home Depot consumer credit card and get no payments, no interest for 12 months on any kitchen, bath, or window treatment purchase of $450 or more. Nobody else has more know-how to make every dollar work harder. So go ahead, give your home a fresh start for the new year. Find more inspiration at homedepot.ca. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
There was a delivery boy here. Outsiders are forbidden.
It's Delicio.
You cannot fool an old master. This is delivery.
Hey. It's Delicio, master.
Your senses deceive you. This is delivery.
He who hesitates
loses last slice.
With its fresh baked taste and delicious toppings, it's not delivery. It's Delicio. And try Delicio Spicy Chicken Deluxe.
A look at downtown Winnipeg. This is a terrific city, and they have been great hosts for the 2005 Canadian Open at the MTS Center. Looking at the semifinal action, it was a count of two for the Randy Ferbey team. It's all tied up against John Morris into the fourth. A steal of one by Glenn Howard in the third gives them a 4-0 lead, and that is the semifinal we will be attending to right now inside the MTS Center. As the fourth end begins. And let's meet the team for Glenn Howard's squad. A new front end. It used to be the lead and the second for the John Morris team. Craig Saville and Brent Lang. Richard Hart has been with Glenn Howard for a long time. And for Kevin Martin, you're getting to see these names and faces once again. Martin, Walchuk, Rycroft, the new dad, and Don Bartlett. The action in this semifinal on sheet C, fourth into play. So Kevin Martin in a bit of trouble with that 4-0 lead. However, we have seen him come back from a bigger deficit.
And we keep talking about that deficit from our local Winnipegger Jeff Stoughton when they were playing the BDO Curling Classic in Hamilton.
Stoughton got five in the first end, and Martin came back to win it. Stole it in the last end. But nobody expected this today, you know. Everything Kevin Martin has done gambling-wise so far in this game has absolutely backfired, mainly because the Howard team is making everything. If we look at the vote that was on the World Curling Tour website coming into this event, 21% voted and they thought Martin would win this event. 12% said Ferbey, 11% said Howard, but Martin not looking very good for his 21%. He's going to be letting a lot of our viewers and a lot of the voters down if he doesn't make the big comeback here. He is the only team in history to win all four of the Grand Slams, so it's pretty natural to pick him coming into an event.
And with the fact he didn't qualify for the provincials, this event becomes very important. Canada Cup becomes very important for him as well, so now his attention is focused on these events. Don Bartlett, who didn't play in the Northerns because of some back trouble.
Ken Trollenberg, generally their fifth man, played instead of him in their Northern playdowns, and they never really got close to making those provincials in Innisfail as they lost out of the C event finally last week.
Well, Don Bartlett didn't think it was worth it. Their main goal is the Olympic spot. That's what they really want. And he just didn't think it was worth it to go up to the Northerns and play on heavy ice.
And this game is huge in the Canadian team ranking system. If Howard wins this, he's only 18 points behind. And the other thing, too, Howard has only counted so far six events on the tour. He's got two more he can count.
And even with a bad back, he apparently has rebounded well. Lead numbers brought to you by M&M Meat Shops.
He even skipped the final game of the round robin just to give his back a rest and actually had Kevin out there sweeping.
Well, he's a very tough competitor. Corner guard could come into play here in this end as Martin really needs something to generate some points.
Normal!
But Howard hanging. Howard team curling spectacular games so far.
And as you mentioned, Ed, they are into their provincial playdowns in Whitby for Ontario. Wayne Madaw will also be there.
A very strong field. They're probably the only key one missing is Mike Harris.
And that's at the Iroquois Sports Complex in Whitby.
It.
They have been pumpkin
it,
prime. I went
corner.
To the media day at the Whitby Curling Club. Had a terrific time, and they are really excited about it. They've got a big countdown on the wall of the curling club. They've been Xing out the number of days to the start of the provincials. They're ready to go. Here's Pops Rycroft.
He is just really...
He's over the moon.
Oh, over the moon over his daughter, Lee, and she called home and said she smiled. She smiled.
Clean. Yep. Okay, bye-bye.
Well, this team has played an awful lot this year, and you know, they might be a little bit worn out coming in.
Sit down.
You know, over the last few years, they've just been playing continuously, so they could be a little tired.
And Marilyn, this will make you smile. Here's a picture of the Rycroft family.
His wife, Sheila, on the left, and son, Jaden, and their daughter, Liam. Of course, we know that. Look, there she is. In pink, as a girl should be.
And during the Christmas Skins game, we had Carter at home on the phone talking to us and talking to Pat Simmons, his substitute player at the same time.
Pretty good sub they found.
Good, clean, cool. Well, so Langer. Good, Bobby.
Thanks. Our team getting rid of the corner guard.
As you mentioned, how important the Martin team is finding it because they want to get that Olympic qualifying spot. Pal Trulson in the newspaper today said he... not really worried about the Olympic experience again. He's more interested in the Worlds.
Line might
he said
be a little tight.
He had a great time in 2002. Delighted he won the gold medal, but his concentration is more on the World Championships than the Olympics.
And he really kind of stabbed himself in the back last year because in the semifinals he had a shot to win against Peter Lindholm in the semifinals in Sweden and missed the 4 foot, ended up losing that. So he's still chasing that World Championship.
Looking at the second numbers between Rycroft and Lang, 100% right now for Brent Lang, 92% for Carter Rycroft.
Freezing the top one probably.
Yeah, you could get the open one. It might be the shot here, guys.
It's not bad.
All his rocks should be close together. I think I like the back one, yeah.
Just peel it.
He could go around.
Just peel it.
But that's fine, too.
That's fine.
Want to peel it, or do you want to just hit it instead?
The same things we saw in that other game. Sometime when it's not sitting real good, you hit the easy one and let the other team set you up for the double.
Richard Hart curled with Mike Harris for a long time, but hooked up with Glenn Howard. He's in his fifth year with this team.
The combination has proved to be a strength here on the Grand Slam. I really like the technique that Richard has. He's a relaxed player, but really lets Glenn know about what the right shots and calls are and sort of gives him that affirmation on the ice.
He's very knowledgeable, very supportive, and, you know, he's a good engineer. He doesn't let his skip make any critical mistakes.
Around. Outside. Same spot, perfect.
Hey?
Same spot's perfect. Or, well, you want to be second shot or third shot.
Well, these two teams kind of a different year setting up now. Howard's in the playdowns, Martin isn't. Martin's in the Canada Cup in March, and Howard isn't. They're pulling for each other off the ice to win and get out of the way, and then the other guy would get the 10th and final spot in the trials from the Canadian team ranking
system.
Both
the same line as Carter's. It should be keen down there.
Yeah, it's lots of weight.
Well, they're trying to avoid the trouble of setting anything up for doubles, so they are also playing to the side one more time.
Shot.
Just a delay action here to see what Howard does. Howard might be able to hit that top yellow and spin it across to get the double on the side yellow.
Yeah.
Walchuk said they just did not play well in the playoffs. Didn't enjoy the ice. And Kevin Martin kind of has that in his past. If he doesn't like the ice or the stones, he can struggle.
It gets into his head and it starts working on him.
A real finesse player here, Richard Hart, yeah.
Big backswing on that one.
If he had had Martin-ish type weight, he might have been able to spin that right out.
Yeah.
Oh, Howard making a move on this yellow stone that's causing a lot of problems in this end. Jam is natural there.
And the third numbers. 100% for Rich Hart, 79% for Don Walchuk.
Don's been struggling at different games here and there, not coming with that consistent 85-87% that we usually see him at.
But while you look at the middle of the lineup for the Howard team, 100% at second, 100% at third, they've just kept the pressure on this Martin team from square one, and they have the hammer too, so they've had control.
Try shot.
Fine. Trying to work the deuce is Kevin Martin, trying to set it up.
Right there, probably best. Even right into the 8 foot, right?
Regular?
Yeah.
Firm regular?
Firm. Good.
Making the roll on this shot is important, but not making it too good.
Got to roll it in just a hair.
How far do you just hair?
Well, I'd like to move it a couple of feet into the 8 foot. Take away the double.
If they roll basically to the beginning of where the lettering is, they certainly do make a tougher angle for Martin to double.
Yeah,
it would make it for a steeper angle.
Glenn's the type of player, too, where he shows his emotions on his curling broom. I mean, you can tell when he's intense, you can tell when he's struggling. And I see a very confident player right here.
But he always shows up with that picture-perfect delivery, which just repeats over and over again very well.
Okay. Way too much roll.
Roll just leaves the one blue counting. And you can see the look on his face. On the road to the semifinals, Glenn Howard with just one loss, and that was in the round robin to Kevin Martin, who was in his pool. 8-4 loss. Came back with a strong 9-4 win over Vic Peters last night in the quarterfinals.
Well, we usually don't see a pretty simple shot like that in a rollout from Glenn. Well, in that game last night in the quarters against Peters, he jumped into a 4-1 lead and then took it to 6-2, and he led Peters the whole game. It was a 3 in the third in for the 4-1 lead, which really led to that 9-4 win. And they played well.
Hard, all the way, all the way.
The blue out of the way. They just want to spread the granite across the rings, and they do right at the tee line.
Well, that's a good position. There's a double there, but it's also the kind of double you could play and fan totally because it's pretty steep.
And there is how Kevin Martin got to the semifinals. 4-0 in the round robin. And against Paul Trulson, 8-6. Yeah. I asked Kevin at the start, I said, is that a little satisfying, a little payback? He said, yeah, maybe did it a couple years too late.
Yeah, getting revenge for the
Olympic.
And I like Trulson's comeback was, well, I'd rather be playing in a world championship than an Olympic gold medal final game. I didn't quite understand that one.
Well, Glenn will go for the double here, but first things first, you want to make sure you hit the one and look for the double second.
Yeah, hard. Real hard.
He got it a little inside, probably making sure he didn't fan it.
Hard.
Can they hold it?
One.
Get it. Go.
Did they get it? Let it go.
Made contact, but not enough of a contact. It's a good throw by Glenn, ever so close to snapping that double.
Well, you always say, Ed, that he's got one of the cleanest, smoothest deliveries on the slam. But that one was a little in. You can tell he tells right away to get right on that. Hits it too thick. Makes it interesting there.
Well,
not quite.
Martin with a chance here to get back into the game. A two-ender here. Just tightens it up.
It's all he needs to have this.
And it was Kevin who made really one of the only comebacks this week last night against Trulson. He trailed at 6-4 after six ends, but got three in the seventh and stole one in the ninth for an 8-6 win. So he's made one of the few comebacks.
All he needs this is in the rings anywhere. And there it is, a deuce for Kevin Martin. So a 4-0 lead now becomes 4-2 as Martin gets on the scoreboard in the fourth. Semi-final action of the Canadian Open on Rogers Sportsnet.
Time. It flies. It is now. It starts most fairy tales. It is money. It is precious. It waits for no one. It can be spent. It can be saved. It can be wasted or made the most of. Putting a stitch in it can ward off future troubles. It heals all wounds. It builds relationships. It is eternal. It's time to get with the plan by Investors Group. A personalized approach to financial planning designed to help you prosper now and over time. Let one of our qualified consultants show you how the plan can help you for a lifetime. The Plan by Investors Group. Sometime between Friday's late night dip and dinner on Sunday, the moment may be right, and you can be ready to respond to your partner, even if you suffer from erectile dysfunction. A variety of treatments are available, so ask your doctor which treatment option is appropriate for you. When the moment is right, you can be ready.
It's not about the money, the glory, or stepping up to the podium knowing you're number one. It's about taking the time to do your best. Like Kevin Martin, our pharmacists take the time. Time to care for you and your family. And caring is the most important part of healthcare. Talk to your local pharmacist at one of these fine stores.
At M&M Meat Shops, we wanted our name to reflect more of what we offer.
Hello, M&M Meat, and hundreds of mouth-watering complete meals you can prepare quickly and easily to please the whole family shop. Can I help you?
But then again, why not just show you? All your party foods and complete holiday meals, like stuffed turkey breast with farm vegetable blend. And decadent desserts, like chocolate caramel pecan cheesecake. M&M Meat Shops, hundreds of meal ideas, one aisle.
Looking at the semifinal between Randy Ferbey and John Morris. John Morris needing to get a little draw activity going to take one. He found himself in a bit of a problem there.
Yes, Rob. They'd skipped himself into a bit of a mess, and a nice shot by Nedewin on his last rock left him counting the host big time, and Morris played a very ticklish in-turn draw. And he had to be right on the side of the button. Not much room for error here. Mark and Paul jump on the sweep at the hog line, and as the rock begins to over-curl, it looks like he's not going to get there. But luckily for him, a little chip and then spin, and he buys more of the button than the Ferbey team and takes one.
So it was a one for John Morris. He has the lead 3-2 into the fifth. Glenn Howard with a 4-2 lead over Kevin Martin in end number five.
Hard. At least halfway. Come on.
Hurry.
Hard. Come on. Right up, guys. Get it over. Come on.
Okay.
Right up.
Can he do it again, Kevin Martin? No, he stole that first slam of the year from Stoughton when trailing by five after the first 10. Can he do it again here?
Be able to get
this is
now.
The Grand Slam of Curling with Marilyn Botto and Ed Lukowich. I'm Rob Fultz. Nice to have you with us. More curling on Rogers Sportsnet. Event three. It all wraps up with the Players' Championship. St. John's, Newfoundland at Mile One Stadium.
What an arena to be playing in here at the MTS Center.
Fantastic.
Top 12. It's hot.
And the crowds have come out. Of course, this is Manitoba, and they love curling in this part of the country.
I was to a game for the Manitoba Moose here, a hockey game a couple of weeks ago. It was cold that week, but this venue sure shows well.
Get a look at the venue here.
They only get, 15,000 people out here for a Moose game?
Our crowds have averaged 6,000 to 7,000.
This has been a record Grand Slam crowd. They have certainly come out and been entertained by the action they've seen.
Line's good.
This is right downtown. Used to be the old Eaton's building.
Line looks pretty good.
They put the MTS Center right in the middle of activity.
Line's okay. Freeze it. Whoa, plenty of room. Freeze it. Line's good. No bounce.
And we'll probably see this venue again in the future. The World Curling Tour has it tied up for the next 2 to 3 years, so we will definitely see a slam here again.
Well, we mentioned at the start of the show that we are going to make the call, and we've got a special curling panel that will decide which semifinal. And I said it was all-star, so after the first three names, then the all-stars start to set in. George Carey's, Gary DeBlon, Jim Bender, Jerry Gertz from curlingzone.com, Jim Bender, local media. And they will decide which we'll concentrate on for the final five ends. you guys at least starting to get your voting together?
Line any good?
Yep. Well, Gary DeBlond and his history, he won a mixed championship early on with Bushy here out of Winnipeg, and Gary with the CCA for a number of years. And he's doing statistics with us this week as well. Jim Bender, curled in the MCA, one of the great reporters from Winnipeg here, and everybody knows curling.
George Carey's from our Canadian Curling News, and also run some of the Grand Slam stats here.
Well, I'm voting for Falsey.
I'm voting early and often.
He's the only one in the booth with an 8-ender this year.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you. Yep.
We can vote him off. That's our vote.
Yeah, okay, we can vote him off the island.
Off the island. Doesn't go like that.
Yep, hard. Line's real good.
Come on. It's long guard for this end. Martin team trying to establish some rocks in behind to get some steelage going against this tough Howard team. And Maryland in Ontario to play downs. Who are you kind of looking on the men's side, first of all, to win? You've got Madaw in there, you've got Corner. This Howard team is really playing well. Who do you like?
Well, they say there's two teams in the Ontario men's provincial, and that is Madaw and Howard. And then comes the Peter Corners. You've got Brian Cochran back.
Ziola's there.
Kirk Ziola. And then you've got this rest of these teams that will nibbling away at you. You've got to play well.
Greg Balsden's also in the mix, too.
Yeah, and he's got Adam Spencer playing third for him. A great combination. Greg's got a lot of guts to play.
Pretty good.
Well, we know this front end can really play Lang and Saville. We know they won two World Juniors with the John Morris team. And they said that playing John, last year for the first time really felt kind of odd. The first time they played him, they didn't know who to sweep for, but after all those years of curling with John.
Now, we've mentioned the Canadian team rankings and the standings there, where point totals will determine who gets an invite to the Olympic qualifying. Now, Randy Ferbey and Jeff Stoughton are already there. That is why they're highlighted. But you take a look at the points and how close it is between Kevin Martin and Glenn Howard.
And that makes this game today huge. But one point to put in there is Martin's already counted 8 events this year. You can only count 8. So if Martin was even to win this game, he has to drop some points from one of his other events, like from his lowest event that he won points. Glenn Howard's only counted 6 events this year. So Glenn, although he doesn't have as many, it has got more. He can count you 2 more events.
30 points go to the winner of this event, 50 to the winner of the Briar.
And then the final Players' Championship will really be big at the end, if neither of them have a spot by that time.
And 50 to the Canada Cup winner. So.
Nice shot, Carter. Shoot. Boy.
And with 3 spots left, here are the 7 teams that have qualified. See Ferbey, Dacey, the Briar champion, John Morris from the Canada Cup last year, Jay Peachy from the Briar, team rankings from 04, Jeff Stoughton out of Manitoba, Canada Cup East, Brad Gushue, and the Canada Cup West, Pat Ryan. And you see the remaining events, the 04 Briar, Canada Cup, and the Canadian team rankings.
And it was Randy Ferbey that brought some of those other guys into it. When Ferbey won the Briar again in 03, Mark Dacey got a spot, and then Peachy got a spot for being third. And so Ferbey created a fair amount of that. He picked his opponents.
Side of it.
Just take the top off. Try to get out of this mess. Yeah. It's never looking great, eh?
Does that not look good if we hit off the outside one? Outside blue?
Oh, yeah.
Get that yellow out of there?
It's not bad. That's not bad. Okay. Do it.
Yeah, that was...
Well, Brent Lang saw something, and Howard and Hart liked it.
This isn't bad.
Well, they're looking at coming off of their own stone, jumping in off of that one, and getting rid of the yellow.
Well, what Howard doesn't like here is the fact that Martin's sneaking behind that guard.
He's trying to build an end, and you're right, he's sneaking around doing it. And they got to make this because they're hitting their own stone, and if you just hit it dead on or something, you've accomplished nothing.
Well, he's not going to over curl on this shot.
Go hard. Go hard.
And bumps the one yellow out of the way. One, two, three blues.
And that's sitting pretty good for the Howard team. A very tough angle for Kevin Martin and his boys to deal with.
And a terrific delivery from Brent Lang, too.
He threw that hard. He threw that hard for a Brent Lang
throw.
Play
a pin across the top of that one. Get them all.
How many times in the slams have we seen Donnie Walchuk come up with incredible doubles and triples? And don't think he can see too much of
this. The 7 will probably squirt out here somewhere. Which do you like, thin or thicker?
Let's try thin.
Hey?
Thin.
Thin? Okay.
Get rid of two of them, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Get rid of that.
Walchuk going for the double here, and they talked about how thick they wanted to hit the top blue, which is sitting just off the 12 o'clock position there at the top 4 foot.
For the first two.
If they hit it real skinny, they could get the top
there,
two.
Right?
Yeah, that's what they're talking about.
Try
hit it skinny. Bigger the weight, the better, because if you're going to hit it real skinny, you need lots of weight to move the top one.
This is where you just have to focus in on the broom. Look at nothing else.
Ah, the broom is only a guide.
And I don't like the word tight coming out.
Whoa. I'm going to go thick way.
Going thicker. Got the one and...
We can do that.
Interesting the way those are just side by each. You couldn't get them closer
right
than that.
Right between the two. Still not too bad.
And right between the house and the barn, says Martin, with that throw, as we didn't get it thicker and we didn't get it thinner either.
Not too much they could really do after it was tight.
Hey, Howard's problem now.
There.
Needs the guard, most likely.
Is that yellow?
Yep.
That may be too much ice.
This isn't an easy guard, though, because you can leave a hole. Martin would pummel through there, and if you overcurl a little bit, Martin can probably throw hard enough to get that, hit anything on the outside of what he can see and get them both.
Richard asking for less ice on this guard.
It's heavy.
You ask for less ice and then you throw it heavy.
Mine's real good.
Freezing right into it probably does not accomplish the job either.
Trying.
Well,
369 is good time.
Oh, he's got lots of weight.
White, perfect.
Slow down. Okay.
That's pretty good.
Pretty much have to make the double. So it's definitely not going through the hole.
No.
Trying to get nose.
Want to just place hack weight at it and stick it on the nose?
Yeah. Can. Certainly can. You know, just as long as we ever get a chance to do anything else. Right? That's the worry.
We got nothing right now.
Any doubles?
No.
Well, yeah, there's this double, of course, but it jams right into here, dead buried.
Well, we gotta hope we get a chance to run something.
Yeah.
Well, he could throw it hard and go for all three, but Kevin said it will not fit between the blue and the yellow. It'll end up sticking there.
No, I think when you have that pyramid shape, you're not going to get rid of all three on that kind of angle.
Well, they've elected to play it soft, just hit and stay on the nose.
Clean. Well, clean. Yep.
Leave the big damage for their next stone.
One blue leaves the picture.
That overcurled.
It did, and it's really difficult to tell what they're going to have because Howard could guard.
Freeze, does only one of the blues go? Did both of them go?
You had a hard time getting that one.
Yeah, that one stays, right? It's just freeze on here?
I think so. You don't want to move it. Well, I guess you could move it a little bit, but... Nope.
short's good.
Well, it could, well, could it be a counter later right on if we hammer something in here. Yeah, probably.
I don't mind that, right in here.
Okay, well, there, yeah, there, yeah, there, here or there, yeah.
Marilyn, an interesting call here in the fact that when you find this probably with less experienced teams, when do you come right in and when do you stay a little bit out with your shooter and just guard? And they've talked about whether they should come right in.
Yeah, you're right. And sometimes, yeah, you know,
we're going to just get an update here from the other semifinal. John Morris's last rock. Randy Ferbey does have the hammer.
An inside roll here would be perfect. For John.
No.
Waiting
no,
for
no,
it
no,
to
no.
move.
Hard. Hard.
No. Okay.
So Ferby still to come with his final rock.
Yeah.
Line's good.
A little left.
No there.
Oh. Well, line's good. Whoa.
A little bit of room.
You hit that one. You turn just rubbing
room.
The spot.
Room.
Huh?
No room.
Lock right to it.
Well, right off. Where's second shot?
Like, I'm not worried about this.
Right
one.
No bump. No
I'm just
going
thinking
down.
We can skinny bump.
No.
Just want to freeze that in.
Shot.
Nicely done. Two blue counting.
Going to be going sideways there.
And one rock to come as they take a look at their options.
See,
yeah, you're right. You
I'm just thinking, what's the easiest way to score one here?
One. Like, well, no, but we don't get shot if we jam that.
Well, that's what I'm just, well, you have to get to the inside.
Which way? This way? All right.
I'll turn.
Just enough to move it back then.
Well, no, you got. It's going to be going sideways there too, so you still got to throw a nine.
Yeah, yeah.
This attempt will only be for a one-ender. They've got to come on the out, turn and tap that back.
Oh, you think it'll go that much? Yeah, maybe. All right.
A lot of discussion on weight.
They mentioned a nine, which in their system would be back ring weight. Just enough to move the blue and roll their shooter right on the top of the button. And it has been Nedwin who has been inside on a few of his outturns so far. They hit that one early.
There's the quick, yep.
Hard!
Huff and Puff working hard on this one. And it looks like it's dead in the water. Will it be a steal of one or two?
Looks like it's a steal of one for John Morris, and that will certainly help out his cause against Randy Ferbey at the fifth end break. So an opportunity for John Morris, right. Picks up one to lead 4-2 at the fifth end break.
Kevin Martin's taking quite a bit of time to look at this, and Glenn mentioned. His opponent mentioned that one right on the button was going to be difficult to get at, no matter how hard Martin hits this, because of the angles. When you look from this angle, Martin can't even see all of it past the guard, so he's got to play a little softer weight. Get some
hard
curl towards. At the end.
Hard, real hard, guys.
The first of the skip rocks.
Real hard! Come on, get a fly, hard!
Got to make sure, first of all, they get by so that rock's left in a good position for his next one.
Well, he squeaked by, first of all.
Pushes the blue out of the rings.
Yeah, going north. Good shot.
And it might be a good enough angle that on a next one he could get rid of the blue.
Well, Kevin really needs to put a good rock position for his last rock. And as you said, Ed, there was no way that rock was moving off the button.
And although a steal would be big here for Martin, also holding Howard to one.
This one's tough.
I don't think it is.
Is still in the books.
That one's tough.
Oh, you don't?
You can,
you almost get to the
you can make it
guy.
With a draw and just tap it there.
You think so?
Oh, yeah.
Move wires as well?
If you don't think so, then the guard's a shot.
You want to guard it? You want to hit and roll?
You hit and roll off the back one.
Could just hit and roll. No,
I don't mind that.
Does it?
Yeah, because he can go around the horn on it, can he not?
I'm sorry?
He can go around the horn off that other one.
Too high.
You sure?
Yeah, that's why we should move this. we hit it now, we're okay.
I just can't nose it, that's all.
Well, the nose doesn't kill you.
Oh, sure. No, I don't know. You go around the horn, you can go into his, and maybe we better hit it.
Okay. Let's make the roll.
All right.
You know, the theme to turn. Jeopardy
What's this
ticking
lined
away.
Up to do right now? It's lined up to hit a quarter of this, eh?
Well, there's certainly fear here as hard as Martin can throw that Martin might be able to play around the horn here and get the shot stone.
Firm or regular?
Just regular, just normal.
So this Howard team has decided to deal with it first. They could play around the horn and get right to the button area.
Oh, I've seen Wayne Madaw make those round the horn shots.
Well, Kevin just absolutely loves them as well.
Well, I don't know if it is bread and butter. It shouldn't.
I don't know if this is a Glenn Howard repertoire shot, but we'll have to see what he throws here.
Well, and he doesn't even have to throw this hard. There'll be lots of action for him to get his shooter into the 4-foot area.
It's firm.
No, that's his normal hit weight.
Real hard.
Oh, this
curling
is gone.
Big time.
He's going to miss everything.
All right.
Whoa.
Ooh, and a flash. So wing and a miss. And now what a great opportunity for
Lots
Kevin
of
Martin.
Mystified he is, Glenn Howard. Why did that take off?
The pick?
What the heck?
Good Lord.
No, just like
half a rock.
Yeah, looking at the semifinal updates, Ferbey trails Morris 4-2. They're in the fifth end break, and Glenn Howard with a 4-2 lead over Kevin Martin playing in the fifth. Panel will make a decision on which semifinal to follow in the final five ends.
It's only going to hit.
That's a tough decision either way, isn't it? Can I vote for both?
He's going around the horn all day.
No.
Can you vote early and often?
How does he get his two here right now?
He draws
hits
4 foot anywhere.
No, he's
draws
both sides.
4 foot.
Okay.
Yeah, okay.
I don't know, is that half about right, you think?
Yeah, well, we've got a foot half. Got to make sure we make contact with that.
Yeah.
Fans here at the MTS Center get an extra opportunity to get a look at how each house shapes up. The big scoreboard at roof level has been showing the Sportsnet broadcast, so they can get the overhead view and see the way the rocks are setting up. So a terrific view for the fans, too. Not a bad seat in the house, then.
There isn't a bad seat in this house.
Oh,
well, the seats behind us, they might be the bad seats, you think? Oh, they're still smiling behind us.
Martin mentioned that he's got to hit this skinny enough that he doesn't just roll over the top of his own. If anybody can do this, he can. Plenty of weight.
Difference in weight from Howard's rock to Martin's.
Come on! Look at that!
Wow, didn't he made Howard pay for his miss big time.
And with some urging of that blue stone by Don Walchuk. Get over, and it did.
What is that? Hair stick.
Well, the difference you said in weight there, Rob, is this is what makes the shot count. And Glenn Howard didn't have that, and you've seen Kevin Martin do that a million times over.
Well, if Howard made this shot, he might have been able to salt this game away, but now he's in trouble.
Look at the Walchuk Watusi here.
You can't touch it. It's not behind the tee line, so.
Well, you can always pitchfork it out of there, and that's what Walchuk tries to do.
A little work of English there, trying to get that extra roll. Worked perfectly.
Howard didn't think he'd have to face a tough shot like this.
And after having a 4-0 lead, look what Kevin Martin's done again.
It's not surprising. Just see how much coolness Glenn Howard has in that intern.
Looked like a good throwing. Sweeper's working this hard to keep the line straight.
The line is way out there still. Let's see what it does after the hog line.
Well, they're going for weight now.
Go, guys, go. Go, go, you got it. You got it. Go, 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 go. Go, go, go.
Trying to get it.
Whoa. Whoa.
Now the whoa.
Oh, boy. Good people.
Unbelievable judge of character and weight for this Howard team.
Now, is it blue?
It's blue.
It's blue. My goodness. Glenn Howard saw a terrific shot by Kevin Martin and had to come up with a nice little touch shot of his own. 5-2 Howard leads at the fifth end break. Semi-final action continues on Rogers Sportsnet. Ferbey and Morris in an all-Alberta affair. And Ontario and Alberta squaring up in the second. Glenn Howard and Kevin Martin. You're watching the Pharmacist Grand Slam of Curling, presented by M&M Meat Shops. Fifth end break on Rogers Sportsnet.
Time. It flies. It is now. It starts most fairy tales. It is money. It is precious. It waits for no one. It can be spent. It can be saved. It can be wasted or made the most of. Putting a stitch in it can ward off future troubles. It heals all wounds. It builds relationships. It is eternal. It's time to get with the plan by Investors Group. A personalized approach to financial planning designed to help you prosper now and over time. Let one of our qualified consultants show you how the plan can help you for a lifetime. The Plan by Investors Group.
Hi there. I need to speak to someone about making my RRSP contribution.
No problem.
I can do that for you right now.
Really? How does that work?
Well, we'll put your money into the Altamira High Interest Cash Performer.
You get a terrific interest rate and a tax receipt right away.
Nice.
Then we'll set up an appointment to do some long-term investment planning, when it's convenient for you.
When it's cooler outside, make it warmer inside. You can at the Home Depot. Right now's the perfect time. Use your Home Depot consumer credit card and get no payments, no interest for 12 months on any kitchen, bath, or window treatment purchase of $450 or more. Nobody else has more know-how to make every dollar work harder. So go ahead, give your home a fresh start for the new year. Find more inspiration at homedepot.ca. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
Every group has its leader. The one that everyone looks up to. The one that decides where the group should go. The one that everyone follows. Because they always have the best ideas. And the coolest toys.
Hurry into your Ski-Doo dealer today for a great deal during the Ski-Doo Factory Clearance Event.
Well, take a look at the fifth in. The shots made by both Martin and Howard.
Well, you know, it's an incredible shot when Martin plays these. Donnie Walchuk urging it out. The crowd going crazy with this one. And then Glenn Howard comes back with a phenomenal weight shot.
Well, this rock didn't really curl for him enough early on. And when you look at it in the end analysis, he did not have much to work with, but placed it in the ideal position to get one.
And a click of brooms, good sweeping. As it stands, 5-2 is the score. Glenn Howard leading Kevin Martin in one semifinal. And the other semifinal has John Morris ahead of Randy Ferbey by a 4-2 score. So very close games. The championship final comes your way tonight. 7 Eastern, 5 Mountain, 4 Pacific on Rogers Sportsnet. Well, Manitoba, the weather has been pretty good in the last little while, so you get outside and you enjoy it. Definitely make sure you wear your helmet. Ow! Grand Slam of Curling on Rogers Sportsnet.
Hey, who shipped the 200 boxes to our client in Boston? Was it you, Lewis?
I shipped them with FedEx.
You're a heck of a man doing a heck of a job, Lewis.
Trust the company with proven reliability. Relax, it's FedEx.
Nobody stands behind their cars like Mitsubishi.
Because every new Mitsubishi now comes with a 10-year powertrain limited warranty, 5-year new vehicle limited warranty, and 5-year roadside assistance. Mitsubishi, the best back cars in the world.
Every group has its leader. The one that everyone looks up to. The one that decides where the group should go. The one that everyone follows. Because they always have the best ideas. And the coolest toys.
Hurry into your Ski-Doo dealer today for great deals during the Ski-Doo Factory Clearance Event.
Time. It flies. It is now. It starts most fairy tales. It is money. It is precious. It waits for no one. It can be spent. It can be saved. It can be wasted or made the most of. Putting a stitch in it can ward off future troubles. It heals all wounds. It builds relationships. It is eternal. It's time to get with the plan by Investors Group. A personalized approach to financial planning designed to help you prosper now and over time. Let one of our qualified consultants show you how the plan can help you for a lifetime. The Plan by Investors Group.
Rogers Sportsnet is proud to present the 2005 Canadian Open. Brought to you by Rexall Brand. Real value, priced right. M&M Meat Shops. Hundreds of meal ideas, one aisle. And by BDO Dunwoody Chartered Accountants and Advisors. Driving growth.
Who says there's no hockey in this country? Plenty here in Winnipeg, outdoors and, of course, indoors. The MTS Center in Winnipeg is the home of the Manitoba Moose. They're on the road right now. They've made way for the Canadian Open, part of the Pharmacist Grand Slam of Curling, presented by M&M Meat Shops. Moving into the sixth end, here's the scores from the two semifinals. Glenn Howard leading Kevin Martin by a 5-2 score. Randy Ferbey trailing John Morris 4-2 in the All-Alberta battle. And the tribe has spoken. Here are the voting results from the Make the Call in our special curling panel. Only you, Marilyn, and I showing great strength of character going with the Howard
alone.
Martin.
We stand alone.
Lukowich carries the blonde. Bender and Gertz have decided to Ferbey Morris, so we will direct our attention to the Ferbey Morris semifinal for Final Five End with updates from Kevin Martin and Glenn Howard. Were you just coming back from the voting booth again, Ed?
Yes, voted a
couple of times, didn't you?
Three votes in all. I wasn't sure if you guys were going to vote again, so I thought I'd toss in another one.
I have to talk to the scrutineers.
Well, interesting enough that Randy Ferbey went with the intern corner guard, and probably well advised, because his skipper there, the guy throwing last rocks, Dave Nettowin, is not having a good outturn game. He's missed three outturns. And if I was this John Morris team, I'd just keep that outturn going. Anytime you're going around a center guard, play the outturn.
Wait on late.
Keep Nettowin throwing that outturn if he's struggling with it today.
What have you noticed, though, with Dave? Is it release, or is it just...
Whoa.
He's flipping it, Marilyn?
No.
Well, he has a very compact delivery. When you look at where his stabilizer is and where his rock and shoulders are, it's very compact. So there's very little room for error. And if he does roll over his hand, it shows up on his outturn release.
Just like a 10 on it or no? Well, I want it back here at least. 11.
Unfamiliar territory here for the Ferbey team having to chase John Morris.
Yep. Real hard. Hard.
Scott on the inside
to the direction of the curl. Hard.
And Dave also a very, very strong sweeper.
Both leaning right down.
You got to give Dave full credit. You know, he sweeps hard for...
I knew that.
You know, helping out on the sweeping system, all that, and then has to throw the final two stones. I don't think that Nettowin on this team gets near the credit he should, you know.
I didn't want to use my...
You know, a lot of guys can call shots, but not too many guys can be one of the best throwers in the world, and Dave certainly is that.
John Morris took some time to talk to Glenn Howard during the fifth end break.
Whoa!
Big flip on the release there.
Well, this team can peel. You know, that's been their forte over the years, is they can really hit in the middle position. And when they get ahead, they're a very tough team to catch up on because they can peel so well.
I don't know, throw a guard up on it. Come around the loop. Back 12.
Around here?
It's not real bad.
These two teams are in the provincial finals in our provincial play in Alberta this year. So Alberta expands from 12 teams, pardon me, from 8 teams to 12.
That's in Ennisville?
Yes, and last year Morris did not fare well. In the round robin, he was 3-4, and Ferbey, of course, won it for the fourth time in a row.
And, of course, with Martin not being there again, it's a big door open.
Hard.
However,
if Kevin Martin continues to march along
atop the CTRS standings, he'll be given an automatic berth to the 06 provincials.
Yeah, go figure.
Yeah. Well, we'll see some other good teams there, you know, that have lost the final last couple of years. Kurt Balderson last year, Jamie King the other year. Some tough teams in there, you know, who are ready to crack through.
John Morris trying to keep this end as simple as he can. Doing some house cleaning here.
Hard!
Ooh, a jam there.
Bad miss.
Come on.
We talked about this earlier in the opening, how the front end really had to play well, you know, especially Mark Kennedy, because he's really been struggling in that crucial shot like that. You can't afford to miss.
No, and that's a hit for him. That's his bread and butter. You certainly don't expect him to come up with a miss on that type of shot. Pfeiffer will try to place that all-important third counter into the rings, and it's always a mystery, you know, and it goes back to even, you know, when Watson wrote the initial strategy book on curling back in the
through.
In the 50s, where do you put that third stone not to set up some doubles and triples? Of course, the one place not to throw it is in the hack. It will just hang on for a bite.
Randy Ferbey's team made a decision to concentrate on curling this year. And basically full-time curlers. They've played 86 games. They've qualified in now 11 of 12 events. They've won two. You see, they're scoring almost 9 points a game and only allowing just over 6.
I think they really wanted to prove that you could curl full-time with a possible full-time check.
Just an inch.
No, some of their goals have been met. They certainly had that Olympic spot sewn up, so there was a relaxation mode going on this year for them. They're not scratching to get at that, which you see Martin and Howard's team doing.
Well, this has definitely been our best year on the tour for stats with curlingzone.com giving us those stats.
Nice
and boy
shot.
We've got a lot of new stats that we haven't seen before, like your scoring average, points for and points against. That really tells you a lot about how a team is performing during the season.
Well, Kevin Cooey's got these rocks set up in the back of the 8 foot there and makes a great shot. Losing his own though, unfortunately.
They'll use this as a guard and come around on the end turn around that John Morris stone. Morris leads it 4-2.
Okay. Line's good.
Randy Ferbey using
Line's
that
good.
Top
Clean,
one
yep.
as a guard, attempting to come behind it.
Oh, yeah, we're tight.
Gave that little soft little release push at the end.
Yep. Whoa.
And here comes the curl.
Going behind the tee line. Ooh. A couple times he's gone behind the tee.
And if it comes out the other side, it just might set up a double on the out turn. Didn't quite come out far enough to give Johnny Moe and his team the outturn double. Looks easy, but you got to concentrate on this one.
Yeah, Kevin getting it sitting in the hack and take that extra time.
Roll then. Clean, yeah! Yeah! Line! Real hard!
kill it.
Well, it's a good thing he threw the extra weight and went tight on that shot.
For John Morris, his team, they've played 60 games this season, 37-23 qualified in 5 of 10 events. No wins. You see in that points for and against how close their games have been.
Well, it just has not been a banner year for them. You know, they've played kind of so-so. And why? It seems like they're kind of caught in a funk quite often between how much offense, how much defense, and all. And so sometimes John Morris just doesn't skip the game either. He'll give it over to Cooey saying, hey, I've had enough of calling the game.
We bring that rock into play. So we might come back and play anyways. Is that what you're saying?
Well, they will ignore shot, Stone, and once again go with the Ferbey intern, Barry.
Same way. Okay, line's good.
Room.
First attempt, he was just that ever so slightly heavy, so he'll take a bit of weight off and look to get it by tight.
Good. Oh, line's good.
You need some weight to work with here, though, because you got to get deep enough that
not quite.
John just can't play the straight back.
Yeah, a little bit.
Got some finishing to do there.
That's where you need it.
Yeah.
Cooey looked at the outturn, and John Morris says, no, no, let's just follow that right in, the intern. In the old days, he might have been playing that straight back. No, but this is the correct shot here. Play that intern freeze.
This is the call.
That's one thing on a tour. You're playing with the big boys now, and you've got to be able to make these draws time and again.
Well, there's one thing that John Morris does very well, and he always doesn't have that pressure look on his face. He seems to be able to relax and have more fun with the game.
Off for a sec. Off for a sec. Ball. Got a curl. Hard. Yeah.
Just for weight.
Hard.
Line isn't so important on this kind of a shot.
Fairly good.
And let's update the other semifinal. Two rocks remaining in the Glenn Howard, Kevin Martin semifinal. Howard leading 5-2. Howard with the blue stones, Martin with the yellow.
Well, Glenn with a hit on shot stone here, and if he manages to hit and stay, we'll make it near impossible for Martin to have a shot for two.
And my three on this shot.
Whoa, whoa, yep, hard.
Nice shot.
And a nice roll.
Very nice roll.
Kevin Martin is only looking at one.
And it looks like he will draw right down Broadway, right down the middle. It's totally open to the forefoot.
Now, how do you know where Broadway is? Didn't you get lost the other night?
Just two blocks down.
45 minutes to go, 10 minutes.
Ed likes to take the scenic route in life. And I'm sure you weren't backseat driving at all, were you, Marilyn?
Nope. Oh. No, not I.
Marilyn the Nagavator.
Oh, so much.
Here's the last rock for Kevin Martin. He needs just to settle this to count.
This has to be good for Martin.
Heavy.
Carter and Don just looking at it so far.
We saw Glenn Howard come up to the bar on his draw.
Will it fudge up in the middle and stop in time?
And is Rich Hart working on it?
No, it will be a steal. It appears to be a steal of one.
One blue.
Yeah. One blue is the score, so more for blue, and Glenn Howard now has a 6-2 lead over Kevin Martin. Kevin Martin and his Alberta team in some trouble in the other semifinal.
Okay. Right here.
What do you think, Jim Mark?
I'll go here.
You could rip this, but.
Yeah. No, he can't come to this one to be shot, so he's got to throw that wide out turn.
No, it's all guard in this. Like.
Yeah. Yeah, well, I think we go here.
I think it's going to be hard to leave a hole, eh? Like, I think we take some ice. with maybe a hair more.
Yeah. Well, we call it a prevent shot. We call it a block shot. You know, make it very tough for Nettowin to count two. If they can play an angle freeze here from John Morris, then Nettowin's going to have to throw probably that out turn again to try to get to the button, and he has not been doing that well.
So, just corner frozen tonight, no bounce.
They talked about taking a rip at the two yellows and determined that they couldn't quite see enough to play that.
Hard line.
Seven.
What? No, weight's good. Weight's good. Clean. Hard.
Wait only.
Mark and Paul on the sweep.
Oh, that looks heavy.
Where are you?
We're seven. We're seven.
You just want to freeze. And they didn't want to bounce.
Hard. Get away.
Oh, and that's downright ugly. That could leave a double.
Well,
two blues.
The weight was absolutely perfect on that. It was just the line.
I don't think we have to throw a whole pile of weight.
I would throw it up.
But I want to make sure our shooter's six, right?
Oh, he will. Just off the nose. Just got to get it out of the forefoot.
All right. You think it will stick with weight? Huh? It's either that or you throw like bumper, but...
Nah, well...
Scott, come have a look, just see what... I'm just wondering if our shooter sticks if we throw weight.
Well, they're going to have a look at it and just see the exact angle they need.
Left, so we hit a little thinner to make sure we stick, but you think if we just throw normal left, we'll stick if we make the double?
Well, you can. I mean, obviously, if you hit it half a rock, you're going to roll out too much for sure.
So what kind of weight?
Easy.
All right, easy.
One thing about this team, they got a whole different nomenclature of what they talk about out there, you know.
Easy. They know what the word easy means. Normal up, normal down, easy.
Yeah, they're always talking about the kind of weight, and they want to hit this just so they save their shooter and crack this double here. And it could be the big three-ender and back into the matcheroony for these boys.
View of Dave Nettowin's very compact delivery, last rock, sixth end.
Easy up. Yep.
Double clutched a bit on that one, and he does that the odd time, or he'll be letting it go and then grab at the handle again.
Clean.
There's the one, there's the two, and there's the three. The double leaves yellow counting three, and now Randy Ferbey takes the lead.
Well, Nettowin tries to make it look so easy with that nice delivery. The crowd's behind him, being a Winnipegger himself. Nice double to count three.
So a little turnaround for Randy Ferbey. They lead John Morris 5-4 after six ends at the Canadian Open.
Every day, you have to work at the things you love. It takes patience, motivation, and the support of those around you. Most of all, it takes time. Like Carrie Burtnick, our pharmacists take the time for you and your family. Visit one of our over 1,100 participating pharmacist pharmacies today. We take the time to care, and caring is the most important part of healthcare.
At M&M Meat Shops, we wanted our name to reflect more of what we offer.
Hello, M&M Meat, and hundreds of mouth-watering complete meals you can prepare quickly and easily to please the whole family shops. Can I help you?
But then again, why not just show you? Complete meals like New York strip loin with gourmet stuffed potato, stuffed turkey breast with farm vegetable blend, and desserts like chocolate caramel pecan cheesecake. M&M Meat Shops, hundreds of meal ideas, one aisle.
BDO Dunwoody is one of Canada's largest accounting and advisory firms, and a very proud sponsor of curling.
At BDO, we believe that all players should be treated equally. As the title sponsor of the BDO Curling Classic, we offered a purse of $100,000 to both the men and the women.
Find out more about BDO Dunwoody at www.bdo.ca. BDO Dunwoody, driving growth.
the curling news, eh?
Subscribe today.
Good look at St. John's, Newfoundland, and we'll be taking the Sportsnet crew there for the Pharmacist Players Championship, March 23rd to 27th at Mile One Stadium, and that's another terrific venue for curling. For tickets, if you're going to be in the neighborhood and or making a trip to The Rock, 1-800-361-4595. There's one thing you know, the hospitality is going to be plenty warm at St. John's, Newfoundland, and the hospitality here has been very good. Richard Deneau from the Dave Bomer team watching the semifinal action inside the MTS Center. He's the second for Dave Bomer.
Yeah.
Seventh end of play. Glenn Howard and Kevin Martin are locked in one semifinal with Howard leading 6-2. While in this semifinal, Ferbey, the three in the sixth, has taken a 5-4 lead over John Morris.
Seeing one of the Bomer players there on the sideline, maybe we can talk about Bomer Night Train, who last year came from PA and took the train late at night. He had forfeited his first six games in the MCA, but came down here and won the rest of his 16 in a row to get a spot out of the MCA at the lower events. And they have now taken that spot away because of Bomer last year. They didn't have and so they ended up with a lot of forfeit games in their lower events this year. In that big MCA field, they've got like something like 450 teams in there.
I wanted to take this opportunity to mention that proceeds from this Canadian Open of Curling will support the Children's Hospital Foundation of Manitoba, and specifically the Children's Sports Legacy Fund, which funds research into sports and dance medicine. Over 130,000 kids receive care at the Children's Hospital in Winnipeg each year, so we congratulate everybody who's come out to watch it and know that the Children's Hospital Foundation of Manitoba will be benefiting.
Well, you couldn't walk in the arena without some of the young characters walking around. 50-50 ticket, here you go, here's your chance.
Oh, I didn't get my ticket then. There's a good crowd on hand, good chance to win a big whack of cash, huh?
Yeah, there was some good money handed out, sometimes over $1,000 per draw in the 50-50.
Yep, don't play, stop, hurry.
Well, this one's taken off.
They stopped, but they're still trying to work on it. Gonna bump the guard.
Well, do you think that in there, that big three-ender kind of took some of the steam out of the Morris team, you know?
Well, just when you think that the Martin team, or the Morris team has got the edge, the frustration starts to show through.
Well, they've only beat to this Ferbey team one out of 10 tries, so, you know,
we're coming right
they
in.
Certainly are the underdogs going into a match like this, and, you know, once again, they've had another end go wrong. But on the brighter side, the one thing they should realize here is that this Ferbey team, although they're a great team, is capable of giving something away. In the first game of this entire event, they led Vic Peters by 1 point going into the ninth end, and they gave away the biggest end of the bonds, of the whole slam. They gave away a six-ender. And that ended it right there. So
yeah, we're bumping it kind of, but
Randy's famous for his offense, and the odd time they can overskip it and get into trouble.
That's fine.
Well, you mentioned Maryland in the opening that it's 1-9, John Morris's record against Randy Ferbey, and that win came in 2003 at the Best Western Wayside in Lloydminster. But everything else has been Ferbey, and the scores 9-1. There's 9-4, 9-6, 9-3. My goodness.
I just keep saying too, John Morris has patience. Randy Ferbey, you know, it's just the bar is so high for that team because they've just put so much work into it. Not saying that John Morris hasn't either. Maybe he just has to wait his time.
And you will find that there definitely are teams on the tour that you can't beat. They've got your number. And if you can switch that around with a big win, sometimes you can get three or four wins against them in a row. It's just a matter of turning it around. Sometimes they will let up and all of a sudden you get that win. And that's happened in the past. I can remember back to the past, like with Richardson and Gervais and various teams, you know.
Hard.
One guy having the upper hand and the other guy coming back.
Sorry, guys. I didn't think it was going to crumble much either.
This is not a bad setup here. John Morris able to use either one of these guards. Soft weight hit and roll.
Board.
There was an article in the paper earlier in the week where John Morris said that he has a difficult time playing like the 14 or 15 weeks in a row because he just tends to get a little mentally tired, and we've seen him before where he doesn't skip, he lets Cooey skip for a bounce or two. And Ferbey replied to that by saying, hey, we've played like, you know, 15 out of 16 weeks, and how many sports do you have to do that? All sorts of sports like tennis and golf. You know, you've got to be playing just about every week to be good. And Ferbey says it hasn't bothered us this year, but they've really dedicated themselves, taken time off work and dedicated themselves.
What's the difference in mental toughness? You know, what side do you look on at it? For John, he's really put 100% into it, but Ferbey's putting 120%.
And just remember, too, that the Ferbey team has, as you said, dedicated themselves to playing this season. That's all they're doing. So when they finish curling, they have some time off. They have some downtime.
Yeah.
A lot of the other teams come from an event, go right back to work, have a full week at work.
School,
and right back into the curling again. There's not that mental time out that they still have.
Well, you bring up a great point, Rob. You know, if you have to go home and be catching up on your job and trying everything, you know, to work hard, and then you're tired when you go to the next field, it's hard to play well.
Well, this is another example of how just great Kirby's playing.
They like these runbacks. It's the old Edmonton runback made famous by the Ferbey and Martin team, and nobody does it better.
And if it's one way to frustrate your opposition, you just keep throwing shots like that. Even though he is so low, Kevin Cooey, on his delivery, his wrist is still way up there.
Well, he was a great young junior player. He lost the Canadian championship on a burned rock. The back of the 8 foot. But as a young guy, he won the Vernon Cash Spiel as a skip when he was only 18 years old. I remember that. He beat me in the final. And this guy was, you know, you knew right from the start he was going to be a good player.
And so, two blues are set up, and Nedewin taking a lot of ice here for Randy Ferbey.
A missed opportunity there by Cooey to get Kevin to get one buried. Randy Ferbey with an excellent straight backer on his first shot will now play a delicate intern draw.
Rim. No, clean. Yep.
Seen this shot played many times so far during this game.
Four. Okay, go then. Line's good. Go. Five.
The anticipation on the sweep is good.
Yep, finish it. Go. Hard, go. Hard. Come on, hard.
Now, we saw a couple switches there from the sweepers as they came down the sheet, as these guys can do.
And then let's update the other semifinal with Glenn Howard and Kevin Martin.
You hear that? The back range?
In a situation where Kevin Martin drawing for one against three Howard stones. They needing a touch shot here.
They have just been totally outplayed today by this Glenn Howard team. They really only had the one end where Kevin came off the side and forced Glenn to make a tough shot. Other than Howard's team has just been spectacular all day.
You can hear the crowd wanting it to woe down.
It does. Martin scores one. It's 6-3 after seven ends in the semifinal between Howard of Ontario, Martin of Alberta. In the seventh end, Ferbey with a three in the sixth to take a lead.
Well, there was a big miss by Kevin Cooey that never got a rock in there, and then Ferbey beat him in behind, and the Ferbey team now applying the extra pressure.
If you look at the forced errors between Morris and Ferby's team, it's the Morris team that's missing one or two shots an end.
We talked about Nedewin's outturn in this game, and you know, very seldom do we get a chance to, you know, because these guys are such great players, to say that what's he doing a little bit wrong, because he's had this outturn moving. And we'll just watch closely on the release. I really like his delivery. He keeps the stone back. It's a very unique delivery, the backswing. I mean, it's just like a small little lunch pail, and then he really keeps the rock back underneath him during the slide. And usually he feathers this back out to the broom.
Might be a little tight.
Very unique delivery.
Oh, line's good. Three. Keep clean. Clean it.
Keep the line.
Line's fine.
Three, maybe four.
We're not in.
It's not
in. Line's real good.
How'd it go?
Yep. Hard.
Well, they did another switch there and went hard at the end to try and get extra curl while it was stopping.
Didn't want to get over there.
Not the perfect rock placement here for David.
Well, John Morris can get at it, but then Kenny manufactured an inside roll off, but to get behind cover.
Pretty tough.
Oh, weight was good.
There's a print, 2 inches of the hogging right in my path. Get it with the hair. With the hair.
Well, the front end, when they're cleaning the ice, have to be very, very careful to, of course, they're great housekeepers of cleaning the line, but when the skip is coming down, they have to make sure and clean in behind him, because quite often you'll get something coming off the slider or the gripper of the skip.
Off. Down. Just back water.
Got to roll it away so you don't make that rock available for Nettowin to get the hit and roll. He's got whole house to roll behind cover.
Yeah, okay, that's fine.
Well, Marilyn mentioned there was lots to roll to, and there certainly is with a hit here. Nettowin can roll that right in behind and get the top button, probably top half a button, and it would make it tough for Morris. Playing this outside in.
Whoa.
The last rock for the Ferbey foursome.
Might have hung this out there and not getting curl yet.
Is
it hit? Will it roll enough?
Wow,
behind cover.
What a shot.
Forced Morris to make a raise back. Well, David's making it look so easy on most of his shots. He really hung on to that intern for a long time.
Oh, he comes ever so close to the hog line, but when he plays with the sensor handles, he's usually proven that he isn't over the line. He only had one during the Continental Cup where he moved where he double clutched. Retouched it. Johnny Moe out of the hack real quick.
His last rock.
Tons of weight.
Trying to get rid of the yellow. On the raise. Misses it. It's a steal. And Ferbey was able to open up a 2-point advantage. Taking three in the sixth. A steal of one in the seventh. From Winnipeg, Manitoba, where you want to take advantage of the great weather conditions for a stroll and a skate.
When it's cooler outside, make it warmer inside. You can at the Home Depot. Right now's the perfect time. Use your Home Depot consumer credit card and get no payments, no interest for 12 months on any kitchen, bath, or window treatment purchase of $450 or more. Nobody else has more know-how to make every dollar work harder. So go ahead, give your home a fresh start for the new year. Find more inspiration at homedepot.ca. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
Introducing the 300 horsepower Acura RL. With voice activated technology and super handling all-wheel drive, power can be shifted front to rear, side to side, and while cornering, the outside rear wheel is accelerated for magnetic-like handling. The road will never be the same. The all-new Acura RL.
Sometime between Friday's late night dip and dinner on Sunday, the moment may be right, and you can be ready to respond to your partner, even if you suffer from erectile dysfunction. A variety of treatments are available, so ask your doctor which treatment option is appropriate for you. When the moment is right, you can be ready.
At M&M Meat Shops, we wanted our name to reflect more of what we offer.
Hello, M&M Meat, and hundreds of mouth-watering complete meals you can prepare quickly and easily to please the whole family. Shops, Can I help you?
But then again, why not just show you? All your party foods and complete holiday meals, like stuffed turkey breast with farm vegetable blend. And decadent desserts like chocolate caramel pecan cheesecake. M&M Meat Shops. Hundreds of meal ideas. One aisle.
It's not about the money, the glory, or stepping up to the podium knowing you're number one. It's about taking the time to do your best. Like Kevin Martin, our pharmacists take the time. Time to care for you and your family. And caring is the most important part of healthcare. Talk to your local pharmacist at one of these fine stores.
That is the trophy they're playing for. The champion of the Canadian Open in Winnipeg. A year ago, it was in Brandon, Manitoba. And in the final, it was Dave Bomer and Glenn Despins. Bomer of Manitoba, Despins of Saskatchewan. Bomer stole two in the 10th, but didn't really matter because Despins came up with an 8-7 victory and a $30,000 first prize check. We're looking for a new winner for 2005. Interesting, Glenn Despin is not here, but there are no teams from Saskatchewan in the field here at the Canadian Open.
Well, we've got the playdowns on, the Northerns and the Southerns in Saskatchewan this week, and so they're determining their teams into the provincial. And, you know, there has been really, I would call this year, harmony, though. Things have been working a lot better between the Canadian Curling Association and the World Curling Tour. We're getting more of the provinces that are working together to try and set a schedule which is friendly to everyone so the players can get the best out of the tour and get in their playdowns as well.
Yes, hopefully next year we'll see the scheduling better, and maybe the women are playing in their provincial playdowns all across Canada, except for Saskatchewan, that starts February 2nd to the 6th.
Well, Paul Boutillier, the director of the World Curling Tour, had meetings with the Canadian Curling Association in Calgary in January. They worked on a lot of issues. Paul met with the MCA here, the Manitoba Curling Association, this week as well. So there seems to be a lot of harmony and good things happening.
Let's take a look at the lead numbers brought to you by M&M Meat Shops. And right now, leans in favor of Marcel Rock at 93%.
You have to have staying power when you're playing in the Grand Slam, especially in the semifinal, because it's, you know, not only how you start the game, but more importantly, how you're going to finish.
A couple of things in this game. Oh, a nice shot there where they get rid of the corner guard and get the bonus. They get the ring with the one in the rings as well, and that's a bonus shot, 5 out of 4, for Pfeiffer as he gets a dual-purpose shot working perfectly for him.
Well, these are the types of shots that Randy Ferbey is so good at calling it and Pfeiffer executing. I mean, like, this is how it's working for the Ferbey foursome.
And if we look at both teams right now, you know, if we look at the Ferbey team first, you know, they're kind of, you know, they're enthusiastic right now. They've come back. They're up in the game. You know, they're even maybe a little bit cocky out there in some of their shots. And any of that might get to the Morris team. If you're one of the Morris guys, you got to be marching up and down the ice and saying, hey, we're not giving in here. Two breaks, we can still win this. One to tie, one to win. You got to be mentally tough, as you mentioned, Marilyn, at this stage. You just don't give in.
There's a very satisfied smile on the face of Scott Pfeiffer after making that shot. That one frozen to the back yellow. And in this matchup between Pfeiffer and Kennedy, right now Kennedy with the advantage in percentage points. Mark Kennedy at 84 and Scott Pfeiffer at 79%.
Well, Mark stayed right with him, and you know, we may see that there was some key shots, you know, in certain situations and made a difference.
10.
Yep.
And 11.
10, just enough to go through the rings. That nope. Back
11.
Ring weight.
Close. 11.
Yep.
Whoa. 11.
Whoa.
And this time it was Nedwin who had the inside of the rock towards the direction of curl. What? Got rid of the back one, which was important. Now if there's a hit on that, on this, the blue leaves.
One of these four teams going in down in the record books is the winner of the Canadian Open. You mentioned Glenn Despin's win. Last time it was held, it was won by Kevin Martin in 02 and won by Wayne Madaw in 2001.
Five's good. Nine. Whoa. Whoa. Wait for
nine.
Five's good. Whoa.
Yep. Nice. Go to move it.
This Mark Shurik ice is so great that you can bury behind rocks in the rings, and they're using that one in the middle of the 8 foot to come right around.
Great shot by Kennedy. Well controlled by the sweepers.
Taking a look at the brackets as they stand right now. Martin, Howard, Ferbey, and Morris, the four remaining looking for a berth in the final and a shot at the $30,000 first prize check. Glenn Howard leading Kevin Martin 6-3 in the eighth, and he has the hammer in the eighth. And a steal of one by Randy Ferbey certainly helped him in the seventh to give him a 6-4 lead in the eighth.
Yep, yep, go.
Ferbey, big weight, playing the pick. Chipped this blue one out.
And
gets them both.
Gets them both. Yellow moves out as well, just the one yellow counter.
He just keeps pulling right out of his hat, end after end. And, you know, this is a tough shot to make, and they're making it look pretty routine.
And that's why angles are so important. That one overcurled, although it really looked like a nice shot. From Mark Kennedy, it overcurled a little bit and set up the double.
Pretty hot.
Positioning is so key on these rocks.
Whoa, still 10.
Whoa.
Kevin Cooley has nothing to freeze behind.
Clean, yeah. Yeah.
Freeze up, too.
Well, they can try to take this deep.
Whoa.
I mean, drawing around a top eight rock shows you how good the ice is, but you have to have great control of that draw weight.
Nedewin trying to get it out the back door, but it's just a tiny little gator back there.
And the comparison between Randy Ferbey and Kevin Cooley looked this way. Ooh,
yikes. Big difference.
11? Well, you're just quiet, right?
Yep.
And if you look back to just last inward, where Kevin missed his berry and then Randy did get in first, that gave the Ferbey team the steal. That's the difference in the game right now.
Yagging up goal.
Love it. Yep.
That's good.
Love it.
Easy.
Oh, hard.
Huff and puff on the sweep, trying to guide this one down to the back ring. Plenty of weight from Ferbey. No harm, though. He nails it and rolls out.
Peels it out with soft weight.
Hairless. Well, I think I got a feeling on the tour over the years that when things go right for you against certain teams, it's easier for you to play. Like, this Ferbey team is kind of freewheeling now that they're up. Everything's going nice and good. It's fun
hard
to play.
Line. Only. Hard line. Real hard line. Hard line. Real hard line. Hard. Hard, you got it. Hard. Hard. Hard.
Cut back on his weight.
Oh, great sweeping there to get it by. Dave's on it again.
Ooh, is it too much?
That is out the back door.
Got it by, but just too much weight. And
well, they had to sweep to get it by. And, you know, when you're being called on the whole way to sweep to get it by and then realizing at the top of the button that it's going to slide through.
Well, when you're using that rock in the top 8 foot as a guard, you got to get quite a ways behind it to avoid the straight back.
We could split that.
Another frustrating rock for the Morris team.
We could split that one. He's going to go around again, eh?
Well, Robin Maryland, the Ferbey team could guard this rock and go for the steal, but they're already two up. So it doesn't look like they're going to do that. They're going to just try to make sure that
whatever you like, Randy.
Morris can't get more than one and that there's no blank left. Take away the blank by getting another rock in the rings.
Well, let's go to the other semifinal for a live update. Two rocks left. This is Kevin Martin's final stone.
Hard.
Get rid of that blue.
Hard. Good.
He will have shot stone and a perfect angle. It looks like he's counting two, so Howard may have to just chip the top one and give Martin a single.
They had a big team discussion on that last shot, making sure that the angles were all there to force Glenn to think about this one.
Thin split.
Whoa, not there yet.
Ferbey team playing the perfect split.
Am I going on this? I don't know yet. Yeah, hard, Marty. Beauty.
Super.
And there's the split. Very nicely done. Randy Ferbey did it earlier in this game. Split them and got them into the rings.
That was a big shot looking back, Rob. You know, that really made that first deuce for the Ferbey team and got them right back into the game.
you got to be able to count in this one or else it's not good.
And now getting ready for the final rock of the Glenn Howard team.
Oh, yeah.
If you do this, then try to pick it.
Oh.
I think you can still feel right on the nose or a hair on the left, right? As long as we stay in
the... Well, but I got to get the one I'm hitting first. I've squirted on the forefoot.
Yeah. Yeah. You get it. I agree.
Firm?
Yeah. Firm on the nose.
Okay. Throw this.
Howard playing a hit on
the
nose.
Sure we get
don't think he can count.
I think we just throw.
He just has to limit Martin to one.
Just control.
That was a perfect hit and roll that Kevin made on his first one to get the ideal angle.
Hard.
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 Oh.
Shot, Glenny.
And it will be a steal of one for the Martin team. So they do limit the damage to just one. And now it's a two-point game with Howard leading. Kevin Martin headed to the ninth end.
One, yeah, for us.
Hard,
real hard.
Whoa.
John Morris playing a very soft O-turn hit and roll.
Whoa.
Try to hit this and get over to the other side of the sheet.
Hard.
Okay.
Hey, Johnny.
Well, that doesn't sit well at all because Nedwin hits this on the nose. There's a problem.
Try this in double and below.
And the skip numbers, 80% for Dave Nedwin, 75% for John Morris. Low numbers for both men. Nedwin, as you mentioned, struggled with the outturn early.
This is a game where Nedwin was definitely beatable. You know, he missed some outturns early on, and if John Morris could have put the pressure on that some more.
Well, and Cooey's, in fact, putting pressure on his skip.
I mean, nose isn't terrible, but
John Morris to come through with some great shots.
It was in last year's Brier on the eighth end against Mark Dacey that Dave was narrow on an out turn.
Yep.
Missed his first shot, and then Dacey was able to pick up three in that eighth end and another three in that gallant tenth end to win the Brier.
Hard.
Nice control weight by Dave Nedewin. Rolls just a hair.
Good positioning by Dave there. He's going to make it tough for John.
If it's
close, Kev.
You'd have to be hitting it pretty thick.
Okay.
Can you? Yeah, you can go. You go right through here. You can do.
Skinny third.
John Morris playing the double here. Big weight on the turn here. Get both of these and spin his shooter out like that. Look to blank the end.
I would think you got to hit this pretty hard and pretty thin.
No!
Well, if he fans it, he still might get shot coming off the side one.
I don't know if he can go through both holes.
Boom, and it will be one yellow and a steal of yellow in the eighth. Steals in the seventh and the eighth end certainly go Ferbey's way. And they will take a 7-4 lead into the ninth, one of the semifinals at the Canadian Open.
Thank you for calling Altamira. This is Eric. How can I help you?
Hi. Is there anyone there who can help me sort through my RSP options?
Sure.
I'm an experienced advisor myself.
What are you thinking about?
We'd like our investments to grow, but we don't want a lot of risk.
No worries. We've got a full range of investment solutions. We can find the right balance for you.
Sounds good. How do I get more info?
Well, I can email it, or you can go to altamira.com.
Perfect. I'm there right now.
Great. How about we go through it together?
There was a delivery boy here. Outsiders are forbidden.
It's Delicio.
You cannot fool an old master. This is delivery.
It's Delicio, master.
Your senses deceive you. This is delivery.
He who hesitates loses last slice.
With its fresh baked taste and delicious toppings, it's not delivery. It's Delicio. And try new Delicio Hawaiian.
nobody stands behind their cars like Mitsubishi. Because every new Mitsubishi now comes with a 10-year powertrain limited warranty, 5-year new vehicle limited warranty, and 5-year roadside assistance. Mitsubishi, the best back cars in the world.
Every day, you have to work at the things you love. It takes patience, motivation, and the support of those around you. Most of all, it takes time. Like Carrie Burtnick, our pharmacist's pharmacist, take the time for you and your family. Visit one of our over 1,100 participating pharmacist pharmacies today. We take the time to care, and caring is the most important part of healthcare.
At M&M Meat Shops, we wanted our name to reflect more of what we offer.
Hello, M&M Meat, and hundreds of mouth-watering complete meals you can prepare quickly and easily to please the whole family shops. Can I help you?
But then again, why not just show you? Complete meals like New York strip loin with gourmet stuffed potato, stuffed turkey breast with farm vegetable blend, and desserts like chocolate caramel pecan cheesecake. M&M Meat Shops, hundreds of meal ideas, one aisle.
Taking a look at the scores from the semifinal action, Glenn Howard is leading Kevin Martin 6-4 after Martin steals one in the eighth end. And the game we've been concentrating on, Randy Ferbey and John Morris, a steal in the seventh and eighth has allowed Ferbey to take a 7-4 lead in the eighth end. John Morris was trying to keep everything neat and tidy, and it got into a little bit of trouble again.
Well, he threw the high hard one here. He could draw on the four, but some flippage from the skip on this one as he gets it outside.
And then you've got to hit the top forefoot rock first before, and he does it, and he's a big steal there for Ferbey's team.
And the reaction by John Morris says that it has been a tough second half at the midway point during the fifth end break. He was talking to Glenn Howard, and he said, well, 4-2 is not bad. Feel pretty good. Just got to keep it going. Well, they weren't able to do that. Three in the sixth, and then steals of one in the seventh and eighth. And Randy Ferbey's team now ahead 7-4.
You can always tell when a team isn't really clicking when you look at the scoreboard and all of a sudden there's a bunch of numbers on the one side happening at one time. And Ferbey's done it with a 3 and a 1 and a 1. John Morris's team has not been finishing off the ends.
I think that steal in the eighth really hurt John personally himself.
They need a deuce here, get back on the scoreboard with a deuce, and then force the 10th end.
Line them up.
Now, John Morris is a pretty superstitious player. You can see out there the boys are all in their red and black, and he's got his lucky shirt on.
Setting up the goalposts here, two corner guards.
Shot off.
Fourth rock of the end. The Ferbey team can peel now with weight. Scott with the wide open peel. And this Ferbey team, no stranger to making money as well. It was a few years ago that they were the first team, and in a race with Kevin Martin, they were the first team to go over the $200,000 mark in one season in total winnings from all their skins games and the tour.
For sure. Look how much everything is.
So Ferbey knows the way to the bank, there's no doubt about it.
Look at that. You got to
show a lot of rotation. In, out. Throw it in, out.
John Morris, body language showing more frustration. You've got to be perfect in all these shots, and Randy Ferbey only has to be half perfect now.
Real hard.
Rotation. We're finding on this ice, this Mark Shurik ice, that you're generally getting best results with about at least two rotations. The rock does two complete turns as it goes down the ice. Less than that, quite often you'll lose the handle or tend to overcurl the shot.
Okay.
If he throws a hair more away, he gets a nice roll behind the corner guard.
Well,
that's the type of shot you really have to be aggressive because although you're just throwing back line weight, you got to have enough weight
just
to roll it over.
One of the house. Try and move ours around a bit, yeah.
I don't mind getting rid of that.
Tough to get around.
You get rid of that, he's drawing around ours wide and we can't even run anything back on it.
Oh, well.
What do you mean?
Okay.
This is like the Breyer thing they had in the 10th end against Dacey, where they've got two of their own stones angle frozen.
Scott Pfeiffer coming out of the hack.
Easy. Clean it.
And it was crazy in the Breyer last year, and the fact that those two angle frozen stones of Ferbey's in the house never moved the entire end, and the Dacey team got around them for three.
Coming up following curling, Sportsnet News with Jim Van Horn. Jim will have an update on the Raptors-Suns game. Steve Nash and the Suns against the Raptors. The Aussie Open wraps up today, and this is Minor Hockey Week in Canada. Jim will have a feature, and that's all coming up on Sportsnet News.
Hard line. Light only. Hard
line. That Nash has had a fantastic basketball year. Boy, the passes he's making, the setups, and just beautiful
right
to watch.
MVP.
Yeah. I think it's good.
No, we're not. Should stay.
I don't know.
Oh, that might be a little strong.
Hit a sand trap, baby,
hard
right
jump,
now.
Hard jump.
Nice third shot.
Why did you move our
grip?
Not
that bad.
No.
Okay. What are you throwing?
Just through.
Okay.
What? No, we'll go after theirs. And we kick ours, it's not the end of the world.
Well, John Morris, who was in charge after the first five ends,
try to get the back one.
Has seen Randy Ferbey's team take five and the lead, 7-4.
I love it.
Well, this tour ice by Mark Shurik is really great ice because you can really work with the rock while you're sweeping it down the sheet. There's lots of move.
Crashes off the yellow stones just around the center line, bounces away.
Well, the sweeping efforts of Ferbey's foursome is always outstanding.
When it breaks, it breaks, and you have to try to catch it.
They didn't really accomplish a lot either. Didn't really open it up.
Yeah. T-line.
Yeah.
John's just trying to generate more of their blue rocks in the house.
Good.
Complicate manners.
Well, for our young viewers, it's really an interesting way John is trying to build this house and try and get some points on the board. He's not even worried about being shot stone at this point in time. It's just a matter of getting rocks hidden where the Ferbey foursome can't get at them. This is the shot he overcurled on the seventh in. Looks like more weight this time.
Line's good.
Roof. Six. Yeah, line five.
Whoa.
Whoa. Hope you can, guys.
Whoa.
Wait for it. Wait for it.
Curl.
Whoa, Paul.
At the end.
Five.
Hard.
Hard,
guys. Line's good.
Hard.
Hard, right up.
Go. Gotta be deep enough.
Hard. Go.
Nice weight and everything. Didn't look like it finished quite as hard as it could have.
There's Paul Trulson, the 2002 Olympic gold medalist, enjoying Canada's finest.
Looks like he's got a good hair day going. Not playing today.
Well, what a big moment this was for Paul Trulson. Ed, you were on hand watching him take the gold medal.
Kevin Martin played an outturn draw on his last rock at the Olympics and was a tiny bit heavy. Trulson went on and won gold.
Well,
they are such a humble team, such a wonderful team, and they work hard at their game, staying in tremendous shape. And
being acknowledged by the crowd at the MTS Center on the big screen above the ice. He now wants to get a world championship under his belt.
He wants to go to Victoria for a vacation.
I think so. Maybe the weather is what he's looking at.
I know what you mean.
Well, we had seen him in 2002, just before that, before the Olympics. He'd come to a North American event, I think it was the Sioux, to try to get some North American experience and play these teams. He said, I'm just using it to try to prepare for the Olympics. Well, he prepared extremely well.
One thing about Sweden, though, is, Norway, is that they actually end up picking their team. Trulson did not win Norway last year, but he still got to go to the Worlds because he is the number one team in the country. So that's kind of nice when you can come second and you still go. Ever happen to you, Marilyn?
Never get picked.
I like that, Dave. It overcuts.
Well, what about a 7 on that?
On which one?
On the front right one.
Well, can we get that out? That's
the one. No, I'm not even worried about getting it out. If you hit it right, you get the middle one to the back there anyway.
What's wrong with that?
If you don't, you split them up. We're laying 3.
I kind of like what Dave's calling there. Just because I threw it there, we know what he does.
Okay.
And if we tick, it's not the worst, you know?
Yeah.
Randy Ferbey with an interesting comment there. You know, there's a lot of good shots here. He says, let's play the one that we know the best, the one we just threw. Feels that they can make this.
I hear more ice, Ed?
Yeah, he's got a little bit more, and he might pick up the sweep a little earlier than they did last time. But this team has got great communication. They pick it up right from one shot to the next.
And they just all play their positions so well.
Ted, hip.
Yeah, they really take care of business.
Oh, 11. Yep. Oh.
Line only.
Oh.
Pumping.
Oh.
Pumping.
Oh.
Bumps the blue back. 1, 2, 3, yellow.
Easy 3.
Yeah, then he freezes in there, then we gotta kill 4. Got lots of time.
What if you just play this right now? Comes around again.
Oh, he's hitting something.
Yeah.
How much do you have of this?
It's like just over half.
And the key is to get the inside.
Is there enough room there, Ed Maryland, you think, to freeze
I don't like
on that
this,
yellow inside?
Even if I make it.
He'll be frozen and shot rock.
And then you do the double, and you got to kill.
Got to be tight to that.
Maybe not even shot rock.
What if you make that double and nose right
might
there?
Might not be, you're
can
right.
Can he crotch it somehow?
Now they're looking at the double up top.
Well, we don't want to go here.
I know you can't miss that set, the 7, or you catch that back one.
We could play it with board. Try to leave this one here. Out of control.
What if? Yeah, shut.
Timeout.
First of the 2 timeouts for the John Morris team. They have called timeout, and they allowed 1 minute to discuss their options.
We're okay. We got 16 minutes.
Well, I don't mind.
The only way I'd like that back one is if we could tap it and pass those other 2 and flop in, but it looks pretty hard.
We'll be updating you on the action from the other sheet right next door to this semifinal.
You can see almost 3/4 back.
The thing is,
even if I freeze, then they freeze. John's got to get rid of 4.
If you double, you think he's going to play the crotch?
I think if
you try to slam the 4.
Yeah. How?
So what if you made the double?
Oh, he'll try and tick the 4, you mean?
But what if you
see the time remaining in the timeout. Seconds tick away. And then the countdown clock will pick up again.
You can't risk missing that 7, or you're going to catch the back one and get rid of our blue.
I think we throw a back 8 foot.
Well, you're showing me rolling this way.
I think we throw back 8 foot around. I think it's too early to double.
Why? Yeah. What does he do?
Well, because Kev, he plays the crotch, and it's pretty simple, man.
What if I do this then? Or this?
No, you're right. You're right with your first inkling. This one's better.
If I nose it,
he crotches.
It's not easy. Like
it's pretty easy.
Oh, you're saying hit this one first.
Yeah.
But you're gonna roll to say here.
Yeah.
Kind of roll.
Can you do it this way though? Boom, boom.
He won't try that. No.
If this was at that going that way, I think it would curl enough to.
Now let's take a look at the action for the other semifinal. situation now for Glenn Howard. Kevin Martin made a brilliant shot off a rock that was the edge of the house.
MR.
Was to come in sideways and sit.
Well, it certainly was, Rob, because Kevin Martin spun that one right back up. And now he is sitting really good. And the pressure's on Glenn Howard now to save the end with his last stone.
Yep.
We're not sure whether Martin's counting one or two.
Right off.
He is definitely shot stone.
No, right off. Right off.
No angle on this raise.
Oh. Well, it is a steal.
Could be two yellow. We're not sure.
Well, they said one.
They say one. It is one yellow, and Kevin Martin with a steal in the ninth. Getting interesting on sheet C as that game narrows to 6-5. But Howard with the hammer coming home. One up. Here's Kevin Cooey now. His final stone. In the ninth end.
They used a timeout and they talked about it for a long time and finally decided to play the double. But how this blue one sits after it makes the double is very, very important for them.
So they make the double.
Looks like they may have set up a pretty automatic double for Ferbey at the top right in there.
Yeah, just get to the inside of that, baby.
Which one is it first?
Well, they made the decision, and no matter what decision I think they did make here, Ed, you were leaving Ferbey with something to go after and more frustration for the Morris team.
That's good.
Dave Nedewin coming back to get his first stone of the ninth end.
Dave will be playing the intern hit. And on this stone here, he's hoping to force this one straight sideways and then get this other one with his shooter.
I think we actually have to touch the yellow one first, right? Okay.
Just nip the yellow one, slide over, and get the other blue as well.
Well, really, in a shot like this, it really doesn't matter because he's in a position where he can hit the yellow one first or the blue one. Enough. And he'll get action on both of them.
There's one and there's the other. Very nice little double by Dave Nedewin.
And they skidded in pretty close together, which probably does not hurt them.
I didn't think we were going to get it.
Simultaneously hit.
Went halfway
and a little slide going in.
I knew you were getting the one.
Yeah.
I don't see any other options, Kev. Is that triple?
One, two, three yellow stones.
Does it?
Yeah.
I'm not so sure.
But if you, you know, what's that one?
Let me draw it. You'd like.
Do we get.
How do I ever.
I thought you could out count this one. What if you do this?
He just picks it and I might. He just picks it. I think we gotta throw this. Get our deuce and run.
How are you seeing this play though?
All you gotta do is call. All you gotta do, Kev, is call that double, and this will take care of itself.
Shooter won't spin out.
No chance. It's too high.
Okay.
So it's like 2/3.
Well, that was a good curling lesson right there.
Well, they described it to us pretty well. The triple that they're playing. And Kevin said, will we end up after we get the triple spin out the top of the house? And that would definitely depend on how hard he throws it.
Pretty skinny ice. Saw his last turn flip with the in, but he's playing the out turn here.
Real hard!
Oh, wow. Just missed it. He curled a 1/100 of an inch too much.
Too thick.
I don't think it was there. No, I don't think it was
there. Well, they've got to be shaking their head after this shot. He really needed to hit just a hair thinner. It leaves the worst possible scenario
for
himself.
But did you hear him say, though, that maybe it wasn't there at all?
Well, it's not. Let me just go here.
Well, yeah.
No, it's not.
Who is it?
Huh? I actually would have gone with the intern on that shot.
Oh, yeah. No, it's us, so we could just draw in. Have a look if you want or something.
Okay, as long as we don't give him a triple, how do we give him a...
Can't set him up for the quad. Right?
Oh, come on.
No, they're always thinking.
It's not as obvious as you guys make it sound, I don't think.
Well, taking a look at the efficiency from the Canadian Open, John Morris with the hammer, scoring two or more, 55% first in this event. Well, Ferbey steel percentage is 32%, which is ranks fourth among the competitors in Winnipeg. Morris with a steal in the fifth. Ferbey with a steal in the seventh and eighth.
Past that one.
You know, deep is good, eh? Yeah, no, but that's why I say deep is good.
Well, since the midpoint of the game, the Morris team just hasn't had a good end, you know, where they've really produced and set it up. Anywhere high here, top 8 foot for Dave Nettowin. He'll force the issue.
Good force to be in, force your opponent to one or two up coming home with the hammer.
This is Nettowin's final rock.
Three. Hard then.
375 hard. The split.
Hard then. Hard.
Well, they're really having to work it hard for a 375 hard. As it digs in.
Okay.
And just nothing there. It threw the anchor out. It's one thing about those split times. You just never know when, you know, somebody's pulled back on the stone a little bit at the end, and the split may read a certain time, but that's not what you really got in weight. And everybody throws their splits a little bit different. Everybody has a different delivery.
Yeah, how much room do you have, Mark? None.
I got to hit it. I got to hit quarter.
Play the raise.
Yeah, the raise is a great shot to call for.
Kevin Cooey,
his one.
And Kevin Cooey had them looking at the triple coming off the outside one, you know, these back two yellows.
I think we got to go for the two, eh?
And, you know, two, how hard is it to steal two going home?
I think, well, this is probably one of the hardest deuce shots I've had in a couple of years. And without the guard there, the only other thing I was thinking,
I have to go, maybe go two corners, maybe to try and drive this through.
Okay. Let's go for one. Can I come to that back one? I can come to the back one, eh?
Not this one.
No?
It's close. I don't think so.
Okay.
Don't even think about that kind of weight shot there, John. Just hit the tee line.
Well, throughout the week, John Morris, when he's made the trip down to the hack, has come up 55% of the time with a deuce with the hammer. But in this game, he's had some trouble doing that, and the steal has gone Randy Ferbey's way. This is the last rock of the ninth end for John Morris.
Well, they had a good start to the game, but remember back to the second end. They blanked the first and the second end. They had a draw for three to the 4 foot and missed. That only got two, so they're missing that one extra point right now.
It shows up big on the scoreboard right now.
Straight draw. Whoa.
This is a 366 on the split time.
He will take one, and
he'll take just the one.
Make it closer.
So down by two without in the 10th. It is 7-5 Ferbey. We'll come back with the 10th end from both semifinals.
When it's cooler outside, make it warmer inside. You can at the Home Depot. Right now's the perfect time. Use your Home Depot consumer credit card and get no payments, no interest for 12 months on any kitchen, bath, or window treatment purchase of $450 or more. Nobody else has more know-how to make every dollar work harder. So go ahead, give your home a fresh start for the new year. Find more inspiration at homedepot.ca. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
When I tried the New York Reuben, one of McDonald's 6 new toasted deli sandwiches, I knew what I had to do. I gave up ties and starched shirts for the love of corned beef, Swiss cheese, and sauerkraut on a toasted rye roll. After all, it's freshly prepared when I order it. Some say it was the sandwich that got me to the corner office. Of course, dating the boss's daughter didn't hurt either.
McDonald's.
The MTS Center in Winnipeg, Manitoba, the home of the Canadian Open this final week of January. And two very good semifinals. See the action on the right. That is the Ferbey Morris game. A two-point difference with Ferbey holding the hammer in the 10th. And Glenn Howard leads by one with the hammer. Martin tries to set up a steal. Right now his yellow rock is just back of the button.
Flashing a ticket is good.
Well, if you're hitting the game, you know those two favorite words in curling, up with, and Ferbey's two up with. Howard one up with. And those teams trailing, desperately looking for steals. In this particular in here, John Morris has done interesting strategy. He's gone to the wings with the two early guards. They're saying if we can happen to get some ends built behind both those corner guards, we could make the Ferbey team look at three or four. That one touches the sideboards, and we'll go back into play into the free guard zone. Totally be removed from play until after the fourth stone of the end.
Another very interested member here. There's Brad Gushu of Newfoundland, and they're getting ready to head back home and start their provincial championship. Brad 1-3 in the round robin. Not qualifying. He said, oh, we didn't get it done here. We have to try to go. They're going right home to get ready to their provincials.
He's a crowd favorite, and he's got that sacred Olympic spot in Halifax, too. So he's done a good job this year.
Line's good.
Line only.
Just T-line. Woo. Woo. Looks happy.
John Morris' team trying to play the corner guard game without the hammer.
Is it light?
Just too light. Clean. Yeah. Okay, good throw.
Coming up following curling, Jim Van Horn will have Sportsnet News. Complete rundown of the day in sports, tennis. Of course, we'll talk more about the hockey impasse. It's Minor Hockey Week. Basketball, golf, everything coming up on Sportsnet News.
Well, this in by John Morris is the old goalpost going up there. You get that one buried, Ferbey peels. Now you get two in behind the other guard. First you go in here, Ferbey gets the open one, you come in here again.
Same way.
And then they run the guard, and all of a sudden you are lane three.
Maybe you guard. The only thing is he's ripping this corner into that other one, eh? No, he's going to hit the guard into the one on the left. By doing this. Yeah.
Well, this is the same strategy you use when you're two down coming home with hammer.
A bit more.
And you're going for three.
I love a bit more.
Morris using it here to try to affect a steal.
Got a lot of curling to do to get this buried. Most of the curl is after the hog line.
Well, you want to be deep enough here to make room for another stone. Because you've got to come in here again after Ferbey hits the open one.
You don't want to run the guard into the other one?
What?
Want to run the guard into the other blue?
There's three rocks remaining in the Howard Martin final, and Kevin Martin just laid one on top of that yellow on the button.
Just a perfect shot.
And this end has definite steel written all over it.
That's a shot, Rich.
And maybe even a steal of two to win it.
Even if I peel it?
You peel it, right?
What's he do, go there?
If he ever puts it in the same place, yeah, it's automatic. We don't have a shot.
You bet he does. Time. It goes right there.
I think this is a shot. No,
Howard in trouble.
Yeah, I guess, Glennie, I guess the thing is you're right. He's got to put it back, not show us a quarter here.
Yeah, and I can run that, I can run this, I can run. Okay. If I go down, let's ever tick this or something silly.
Okay, you want to run that into there?
Yep.
Peel?
Peel.
So it's the peel, angle, raise, takeout.
Time for no valor here. You have to open it up.
Yeah, Glenn's really got to leave him something for his last shot.
It takes longer to say the peel, angle, raise, takeout than it will be for Glenn to throw it.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I think he's got to hit the center, doesn't he?
Okay, well, when do we go corner then?
Tight on that.
Glenn Howard's first stone. They're working on it hard.
Is it over curled?
Boy, that turned out very, very brutal for him. That center guard is still right there.
Got it, kid.
Kid me not, you're in big trouble, Glenn.
Glenn Howard's had a few bad breaks in this game. Although he's had the scoreboard higher than Martin, he's lost control on this shot here.
If Martin comes down and freezes that again, it could be game ball.
Martin with steals in the eighth and ninth to narrow the gap to one.
So we got to be right in here.
And this is going to be his final stone of the tenth.
He could guard, but he, you know, when do you come in? And he says this is the situation where we just come in and freeze another one right on.
And they still haven't made a decision on sheet D between Morris and Ferbey. John Morris is still trying to decide what they can do to try to manufacture a steal.
Why, it doesn't matter. Does it?
Is this your first or second?
Well, the big game, the big shot in this game with Kevin Martin.
Higher the better.
The one thing he's got to do here is get the right amount of curl. If he's going to freeze it, he can't just freeze on a half of it because there would be a big hit happening from Howard.
And this is Kevin Martin's final rock in the 10th.
Mine's good.
Glenn Howard would be happy just to give him one this end.
Mine's real good.
Give him the steal.
Mine's good.
Hard. No, we're there.
Whoa. Okay.
We're there.
Okay.
Line over.
Donnie Bartlett saying, we are there.
Yep. We're all there.
Looking awfully good.
We're all there.
Dewey delivers. That one is all there. Indeed. Look at that line.
Glenn Howard, it is your shot. There may be no shot.
You couldn't have picked it up and put it down in a better spot. Tic-tac-toe.
Whoa. No.
Right off. Never.
Situation here where the Morris team decided to forget about both of their own and guard the center line. Now, Ferbey will hit one of those two in the rings, probably. Morris comes around center. But Ferby's not falling for it. He's peeling center.
That's tough.
Not there.
It's real tough. I gotta go here.
I like the way John Morris has set this end up. I'll show try.
Well, Randy Ferbey in complete control, showing us why he's the master of this team calling the shot.
Ferbey doesn't get the double, so not much change there. Now, this shot by Glenn Howard.
Yeah.
If you were in figure skating, you'd call this, you know, degree of difficulty or diving, you know, like this is a 12 out of 12 for tough. He's got to put this on the corner of the button.
Yeah, so he has to do that just to narrow it to one.
The most ice we've seen him take for his intern draw.
Yep.
Final rock, 10th in for Glenn Howard. He leads by one, but is in a world of hurt right now.
Well, you know he has great sweeping.
Got a curl.
The line's
got
to get a whole lot better here.
Got a curl.
Whoa, it's got to bend.
Go. Yep. Go.
No, sir.
Not there.
Is it over?
It is. Martin stole two in the 10th. What a comeback by Kevin Martin. We shouldn't be surprised. We've seen it before. Howard was ahead 4-0, but Kevin Martin with a steal in the 8th, in the 9th, then 2 in the 10th. Charges back for a 7-6 victory and a spot in the final.
Unbelievable. You never count him out. A way to win it is always beyond us.
And what a huge game. Sends them into the final of the slam and also those Canadian team ranking points. Martin really jumps into the lead now that he's beaten Howard in that game.
A guard by the Morris team. And I'll tell you, they stopped and took a good look over their shoulder to see how that final shot of Glenn Howard settled. He got it to the button, but not enough of it. He had to get it right in there in the corner.
It was perfect weight, and that was the most ice I've seen him take all game long for that intern.
Well, you got to take your hat off to Kevin Martin and his team for not giving up. And we saw in the first slam where they trailed 5-0 after a first in to Stoughton and came back and stole that game, stole the 10th in, and here they steal 2 to win this one.
Trying to raise back.
Not much luck, but an angle at least that works for Ferbey. They will be able to come off the side one. It would have been better for Morris had those end up parallel straight across.
Morris team using their second timeout.
Randy doesn't quite get the job done here. But Randy, you haven't missed too many.
Positioning, a good break there for the Ferbey team.
Well, John Morris knows it can be done. He just looked over his shoulder and saw Kevin Martin steal 2 in the 10th to win.
When he misses, he's looking up. I think he might still hit this one.
I think that's the spot. And then what does he do?
Well, he's playing the triple. Just the fighter
actually is perfect. We got to be in. We got to be in. Have you ever tried?
He might just do this. Then you got to hit it. Shoots against 3, I guess.
Yeah.
We got to go, though.
Okay.
Has to be in the rings, they said.
Look, Dad.
Otherwise, Nedwin would just hit the open one and hit and stay.
Got to be in. Got to be in or we're hoop. Yeah, just a 4.
And the first rock for John Morris in the 10th.
They would like to be top 12, but they'd like Nedwin to try the triple, and if he happens to get some bad luck, then they can work on positioning for their last one.
Real hard. Real hard. Real hard.
Number one got to be there.
3-9-0, the interval time.
Oh, that looks like Cooey out to help.
Real hard.
They want it in.
Whoa.
Make sure it bites, boys.
Didn't curl over enough, and Nedwin will attempt a double off the side, I would think.
I'm seeing if you miss it, you're going to have a lot tougher shot.
Yeah, they certainly wanted that rock over more, didn't they, Ed?
Or right now, we just run this one right here, try and make this double. That's not bad either.
Or this way, don't matter. Whichever one you want.
I think we just run it onto this one. Because then our shooter rolls a bit too, right? Yeah. What do you think?
Yeah.
Okay.
And he's gonna replace it. You're just gonna have.
But Randy, if we make the double, then I have open hit. So.
Okay.
This is the most blue rocks David Nedwin has looked at all game.
Well, if we make the double, then we'll have an open hit. So. Right.
They could play the double that is deeper. Randy said if they don't make that, it's not a good situation for them, so they are picking the high double.
Yep.
Nedwin's first of the 10th.
Hard!
Came out with some force on this rock.
Hard! Get it out there. Get it out.
Wow, and he doesn't get that, and his shooter stays for a while. Could be a troublesome rock.
Why don't I tap this?
I don't think this is the shot that they wanted and the outcome. First time I've seen a little bit of concern on the Ferbey foursome.
No, he just comes down to this. I like him playing something off it. I like it.
This?
What are we at for time?
1 minute. Oh, they've only got a minute to work with.
A minute and counting.
No, we got to tap it.
You can't. If you're frozen, he just slashes it, eh?
You see the time, and that is a concern.
Here?
Yeah.
John Morris scurries down the ice to throw his last rock at the 10th end.
He can run out of time in the slam. you can get 3 minutes, but you lose a point, and that's what John Morris can't afford. Can't lose some points.
Move it a foot.
Lots of time, my man.
Yeah, lots of time. He has to cross the first tee line. There he is. Okay.
Whoa.
Ooh, a lot of weight.
Eight. No line.
Why is he heavy?
Eight. Seven, eight. He's
whoa.
381 the time.
Wow. Whoa.
Nothing. Seven.
Just freeze.
Whoa. Right here.
Hi.
Switch.
Just here. I don't know.
Get ready.
Yep.
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 Hard.
Well, they certainly could have been deeper. Could have been right to the top of the button.
Well, something was happening to that rock.
You heard him say it picked just as it started to come into the house.
Really needed to bite that 4 foot.
Any kind of an inside roll for David Edwin, whether it's for second shot or for shot rock,
but, you know, even
either one would work. He's got 2 point lead on the board, so as long as he can get for a second shot, he is the winner.
Well, Dave Nedewin has been very successful on hits through the nine ends, curling 96%. Final rock, 10th end, for a chance to move into the final.
He has not been stellar on his out turn in this game, but he does have some great sweepers in front of him.
Never.
Ooh, did he hang this out? Oh, that's hanging out. He's going to roll out.
He's rolling the other way, Ed.
And there's the hit. Is it good enough? There's the question. They might have to measure this to decide. They are going to measure it. It is one for sure for John Morris. Is it two to force extra play?
I vote yellow.
Too big.
Looks like that.
And here comes the stick to determine who goes to the final against Kevin Martin.
We've been doing this a lot.
Yeah, no kidding, eh?
Well, both semifinal actions coming right down to the last rock, right down to the last wire, and now to the last measure.
What have we got there? Not much on the dial. Nothing there.
It is yellow. It is yellow. They are able to limit it to just one. They're going to check one more time. Everybody interested in the outcome here.
Better be sure. Nothing on the blue and some on the yellow.
It is over. Yellow manages to be there for second. Morris only a steal of one and a 7-6 score for Randy Ferbey to set up Ferbey and Martin in the final. We'll wrap it all up from Winnipeg. My goodness,
sure
a couple of
tonight.
Good semifinals.
Hey guys, so far so good.
There was a delivery boy here. Outsiders are forbidden.
It's Delicio.
You cannot fool an old master. This is delivery. Hey.
It's Delicio, master.
Your senses deceive you. This is delivery.
He who hesitates loses last slice.
With its fresh baked taste and delicious toppings, it's not delivery. It's Delicio. And try Delicio Spicy Chicken Deluxe.
Every group has its leader. The one that everyone looks up to. The one that decides where the group should go. The one that everyone follows. Because they always have the best ideas. And the coolest toys.
Hurry into your Ski-Doo dealer today for great deals during the Ski-Doo Factory Clearance Event.
Rogers Sportsnet is proud to present the 2005 Canadian Open. Brought to you by Rexall Brand. Real value, priced right. M&M Meat Shop. Hundreds of meal ideas, one aisle. And by BDO Dunwoody Chartered Accountants and Advisors. Driving growth.
Well, what a afternoon of semifinal action. The Canadian Open Championship goes tonight with Randy Ferbey's team against Kevin Martin. An all-Alberta battle. A very strong championship. Kevin Martin with steals in the
8th, 9th, and 10th to defeat Glenn Howard 7-6. And John Morris could only get a steal of one, allowing Ferbey to win. Hope you'll join us for the championship tonight. For Marilyn Bodo and Ed Lukowich, I'm Rob Foltz. Take care, everybody.